You gotta go and get angry at all of my honesty. You know I try, but I don't do too well with apologies. I hope I don't run out of time, cause someone call a referee. Cause I just need one more shot, second chance. Is it too late now to say sorry? Cause I'm missing more than just your body. Is it too late now to say sorry? Yeah, I know that I let you down. Is it too late to say sorry now?
Afternoon, good evening, good morning, whatever the case may be. Welcome to the Frat Party, the quarter annual State of the Frat show. Today we've got some special guests from across the metaverse, the multiverse, the NFTverse. I have no idea. We've got, well, let's start all the way on the other end, way down there in the corner with Jordan Orajo. What's up, bro?
I just want to say that was outrageous. The music and the videos were just outrageous. I'm huge. Why is my head always so big when we use this software?
You should ask your mother that.
Well, I was premature, so, you know. Wow, we're just getting right off the bat. We're learning a lot. I got the yerba mate, and yeah. I'm excited. I've been looking forward to this for quite a while. And
yeah, it's going to be a fun night. So, You know what? Let's go around. Jordan is sort of our marketing mastermind, so to speak. Your shoulder keeps disappearing. This is very strange. Anyways, Rolling around, we'll just start with Buzz, who is muted.
What's up, guys?
What's up, Buzz? Buzz, why don't you introduce yourself to the fine people in the YouTube-verse. Oh, I should do the Twitter Spaces thing. Ah, screw it.
All right, so I'm Preston Winters. I'm the head of Cyber Hornets Colony Club. I also advise for the Dragon Guild, and I'm on the, Dragon...
Advisory Council for Club 101 Den of Dragons?
I'm like 2X Dragon Advisor, I guess, in a way.
Double XL!
Yeah.
Nice.
Anyways, so I'm trying to figure this out. I haven't been on this software before, so... Excuse me.
Yeah, this is StreamYard. It's basically just web-based stream sharing. So using StreamYard, you could restream out to like multiple sources. Like this is on Facebook and on YouTube.
Right now. Nice.
So, and somebody, all of you guys, go on the Discord. Make sure you're planting the video out on the Discord. Let's move on over to Matt Albright with Starship. Matt,
Hey guys, how's it going? Thanks for having me.
For sure. Introduce yourself to the fans and the peoples.
Yes, sir. I'm Matt Albright, Starship CEO. I apologize. My camera's not on. I wasn't expecting a show tonight, but I'll get there next time. It's too bright.
All right. And then rolling up next to me, we got Zach.
Oh, is that what we're doing?
Hey, this is what I'm doing. Okay. I don't even know if Matt's here. He's just, you know, he's got his logo there.
I'm here. He's here.
He doesn't want to show his masked face. That's right. I'm Zach. I am the creator of Mavs and Monsters. And we're developing NFT games. Yeah. And incorporating pretty much always everybody here. It's very interesting is that they have Preston and Jordan here, because it's like we're integrating and we're integrating everything into all of our collections through each other. So it's just a wonderful community driven sort of interconnected thing happening. So
yeah, cool. And I believe Jordan will be showing something to how that's affected later on in the show. Don't open your eyes at me, Jordan. I'm not letting anything out early.
This is news to me.
I didn't have time, but I wanted to make the face on my Ben Herrera Yair Berserker thing, like the face of me with my eyes wide open, like the shock look. Next time.
Tongue sticking out. All right. And Matt Cawson, who are you and what are you doing here?
I am a custom artist on the Funky Monkey Frat House, thanks to Mike, and also got hooked up with Dragon Guild. So I'm right now drawing as we speak. I'm drawing up the NFTs, creating attributes. I'm excited about it.
Zach will be representing Dragon Guild tonight, even though no one else from Dragon Guild is here. We didn't invite anybody from Dragon Guild.
Matt will.
Okay, Matt, there you go.
Yeah. And Preston.
I'm here. I'm a Dragon Advisor.
You're Dragon Guild too?
I'm helping them out. So I'm 2x Dragon Advisor.
Excuse my ignorance. I have way too much stuff to pay attention to.
I feel you there.
This is all across community. Everybody's
I can't even pay attention to the stuff that I'm doing. It's just too dang much. So let's see. We do have a little bit of a... You know what? Jordan, you're in charge of the schedule. So okay. Why don't you go ahead?
Okay. So I'll do the, so before we get into other stuff, I just wanted to do some giveaway housekeeping, because people are filtering in here now and they're going to have questions about what's being given away, when, where, why, how, all that kind of stuff. So
I pause you for a second. Real Gizmo for $4.99 says, "What up, big dog, Funky Monkey Frat House? Let's effing go." Thank you, Gizmo. And thank you to Octopi for doing all those funky little videos at the beginning of the show. And hello to everybody in the chat. Sorry, there's 97 of you and I don't have time to read all of your names, but thank you for being here. Although I do want to say thank you to someone just became a member today. And if you want to become a member of the channel, we got Recon John is a new member. Thank you, Recon. Hey. And Pumpkin King is a new member. Thank you to the new members of the channel. Membership is down there at the bottom. And you can use some fun little emojis and whatnot. And there you go. Sorry. Go ahead.
Oh, that's okay. I got a clear calendar right now. Just hanging out. Well, let's see. So I think people have seen the graphic and the visual that has all of the different things we're giving away, because we're giving away a lot of stuff tonight.
So you're saying now, put that on the screen.
Well, that was a subtle hint you picked up. Yeah. You're doing that. So I just want to say to everybody, if you haven't yet entered the Greek Monkey giveaway in our Discord, you should go there and do it now, because so discord.gg/FMFH, Funky Monkey Frat House. So go there, go to the giveaways. We're doing a giveaway that's open to everybody. Anybody, you don't have to hold a monkey. You go there, and in 21 minutes, that giveaway will trigger, and the winner of it will get a frat monkey, will get a Greek monkey. The reason this is so nifty is that if you are listening live, whoever wins this will get your address. We can send you a monkey, and you then will be eligible for all of the lottery giveaways, the ones that are coming up. So we wanted to make it so that even if you didn't have a monkey, there's a chance for you to get the lottery to win the lottery draws. For other people who do not have monkeys, we're going to be giving away Starship packs as well as TCG Silver Plot later. Now, with the Starship giveaways, you're going to need to get a wax wallet for this. Now, a lot of people from Starship and from our community already have this set up, but if you don't, then it gets a lot trickier. We have monkeys standing by in our Discord in the Funky Monkey Space Force channel. They'll help you walk through getting a wax wallet if you want. But that way we can do just random giveaways. Like I could say, hey, I want to see 3 wax wallets in the chat on YouTube. And then we'll get 3 wax wallets. And I'm going to pick the 3rd one that I see, and I'm going to send them a pack. Now, because of a delay, I'm watching. There's one, Jackson Lone Wolf, Shooty Pew Pew, who is winning everything, is the 3rd wax wallet I see. So I'm going to be sending Shooty Pew Pew. Yes.
Shooty won some stuff last night, too.
Shooty won last night at the Starship birthday party. He won the Delta Chimp event NFT, and he also won the Space Monkey giveaway.
Sounds like he pulls that trigger quick.
He's a quick shooter.
He also won a gold plot on TCG.
What?
Oh,
dang! This dude's rigged.
I'm gonna send him. What do you think, Matt? Should I send him a sticker pack, a catalyst pack, or a part pack?
Probably a sticker.
All right, he's getting the sticker pack. Okay, so I'm sending that right now. And it auto capitalized. Okay, well, I'll figure that out. I'm gonna send that right away. Anyways, so that is
W Free said he cheats. That's fighting words.
So anyways, if you have wax, that's how you get your wax wallet. You got to sign up for it, and then we'll do giveaways just by kind of shouting them out either here or in the Discord in different places. So that's the example of live giveaways happening randomly mixed throughout. The lottery giveaways are going to happen at certain times. We're going to have a random draw. Mike will pick a random number generator because last time I didn't like the one I found. It was too boring. So let him pick a one.
And is there one with like confetti and stuff?
So you're going to find one. And what's going to happen is for the custom Genesis, the first 2 draws are only going to be the custom Genesis holders who are participating. There's 267 of them. So we will draw a number between 1 and 267. We will look up that Genesis custom winner. They will win the prize.
And I'm just forwarding an apology here to anybody who's still waiting on a custom. Sorry, you don't qualify. There's really nothing that can be done about it. If you're waiting for your custom, then you'll have to just qualify for next quarter, which we're going to have awesome stuff next quarter that I can't talk about right now.
The growth from last quarter to this quarter is crazy. The growth.
Oh, you have no idea. Next quarter, I mean, actually, you do have an idea. Next quarter, holy schnitz and groovin', this is going to be a madhouse.
So,
but anyways,
Genesis Customs 1 to 26, or 1 to 267, and then for the giveaways, it's going to be all people who are holding a Toga Monkey or a Greek Monkey or Genesis Custom. So we're just telling you now. So if you still want to get in on some of these prizes, you can go and pick up from the floor or the frat pool. If you have questions, ask in our Discord, because we have monkeys standing and sitting and partying by. So then for the final draws, we're going to go between 1 and 2,267. And between 1 and 2,000, that's going to be a Toga Monkey or a Greek monkey. And then if it's over 2,000, one of those 267 are going to be Genesis custom monkeys. It's so easy. I'm so excited about how easy it is this time. And Enigmatic Octopi, one of our faithful, great.
If anything goes wrong, by the way, just please send all complaints to Jordan, not to me.
Sure, that's what I'm here for. Customer service. I'm Canadian. We're bred like that. Thank you. I'm so sorry.
I'm sorry.
I'm very sorry about that. anyways, so what was I gonna say? Octopi. Octopi has gone through the first. So before we do the draws, we're gonna call a snapshot moment, and he's gone through the NFT frat pool and identified all those monkeys so that the frat pool can't win the prize. for people to rise. We're giving away a 251. I mean, so yeah, we'll get into that in later. There. But yeah, the utterly useless 251 who have no utility and are pure vanity. And I have one. I minted one. They're fine.
Oh, I've got some.
Yeah, you got a lot. But you know what? What do they do? They just stay outside in the cold. But that's, they have shields and they look like Spartans.
Yeah. So they're wearing togas, so they're freezing their butts off. But
that's
okay.
Why the grand prize for all of the giveaways is a 251 plus one ETH.
Oh, the 251 is coming with the ETH. Is that
yes.
What's
up? Yes, that's the final prize. You're getting a 251,
all right. Well,
which has no utility, and it's coming with an ETH. Yes, I did that on purpose.
That's funny.
Okay, so yeah, that's good for a preamble. Let's see, what else are we saying here? Oh,
wait. Embrace wants to know what a 251 is. Do we have time for this?
Oh yeah, and Timmy, I should invite him in 1 second.
All right.
You talk about 251.
The 251. So when we first minted our very first togas, we were all dressed in togas. Me and Zach and a couple other guys were here wearing sheets, ready to launch our toga collection. And we went, and the devs said, "Go, go, 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 go." So I said, "Go, go, 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 go." And then I looked at the thing and I said, why does it say these are 0.00001 ETH instead of 0.01 ETH? And then the devs are all, stop. So we minted. We had to mint this contract. People bought 251 monkeys at 36 cents each, which didn't help me any. But it ended up being, something that we had to work through. I had to talk to each individual buyer and sort of work out a plan with them how we're going to sort of make it right and keep everybody happy. And so what I ended up doing was we created a secondary, or we recreated another contract to make the regular togas mint. And then I redesigned the mint for the original mint to be Spartan monkeys, because somebody in the chat, I can't remember, was it Chucky who did the
it was probably Chucky, or was I think it was Chucky.
Yeah, it was a lot of the guys in the chat were like, we are the 251. Mm-hmm. And then they were doing the whole 300 thing, and I'm like, I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna totally steal their idea. Thanks everybody. I think it was Chucky. And turn these guys into Spartans. So now there are 251 Spartan monkeys. I should show them.
Nice.
But let's see. Opens, and they're called the 251 bad monkeys. So they're out there. They have no utility. They're all just part of the lore of the Funky Monkey Frat House. Bad monkeys. Someday they will have their revenge on the world, but until then, they're just sitting there.
And there's only
0.056. There's only like three for sale, I think.
It's crazy to me. There's five for sale, and the price is still all like pretty low, and that's it. Like, it's very curious.
But hey, you know what, dude? That price is like, you know, 20,000x.
Oh yeah,
from the mint price. So there you go.
I remember when it happened, I was like, wait a minute. And I minted one. I was like, is this real? I minted one. And then I was like, Mike, I minted one. I got one. It was working. It's not, it shouldn't be working. Then I felt
and
bad.
We've got an additional guest here. Embrace Life Crypto is.
I'm Jason? Here. How you guys doing?
Hey.
Hey, how you doing?
Is it Jason?
Is it Tim?
I want a 251.
Oh. Sorry, I don't remember.
That's Timmy from. You want to introduce yourself? Alpha.
He's from everywhere.
It's. I'm Timmy O'Neill. I'm from Embrace Life Crypto. Timmy O on YouTube, and I'm one of the partners for Alpha Origins with Starship. And
okay.
We just partnered with Dragon Guild. Hopefully, you guys get in.
Yes.
It's going to be huge, and we work pretty much in all the same spectrums. I think I have pretty much one of each from every one of the products. I don't have a 251 though, so.
Well, there's only five available, so good luck.
you also don't have a metallic dragon from Club 101 Den of Dragons, because there's only two in existence, and neither of them have left the nest yet until tonight.
Well, then I really need one of those too.
Okay, so Paul, you were talking about dragging.
Where is TCG, Paul?
Well, Ben is asleep.
I sent the link to Alex. I don't know.
Yeah, if he's I did. I sent a tweet to Paul. He said he was going to try to be here if he could, but he
has well, there you going go. On. You know what?
Ben is asleep.
I'm TCG.
You are TCG.
What are you talking about? Where's
we TCG? Are? Aren't we all TCG? Oh no, you're TCG.
No. Mm-hmm. I get paid by TCG. I literally
we don't work for them, but we're partnered with them.
Right? Mike does. That's why in the itinerary later on it says, "Mike, show TCG creatures."
When but Zach we won't and talk TCG. About that.
We'll
Zach
get no.
getting TCG. You don't want to be in the metaverse? Come on now.
No, I do. He's just not in there yet, and I'm doing my own thing. I'm also, doing my own thing.
Also, so. Den of Dragons partner, and we have Den of Dragons like. Headquarters and estate and land, and we'll be rolling partners into that. I mean, but anyways, I'm let me finish. Let me go.
We've got the TCG people popping up like I am Spartacus on the chat.
You know what? I was really excited looking at the guest list, looking at all the projects that we have partnered with that are in the prizes. Like this is like the frat party. Like we have so many different groups here and Starship. And like, I'm just excited. Cause it's like all of the friends that are growing.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh my gosh. I can't do all these right now. Sorry. Okay. We got it. We're all TCG here.
Woo! So next I wanted to say as well, cause with all of the lottery winners, all lottery winners will be getting Dragon Guild whitelist for the mint. Plus they'll getting the OG pass, which is like a special thing on top of that, which I think I saw in their Discord earlier. They were saying that might actually give people more whitelist minting than just the whitelist. I don't know if I can say I've heard that. So anyway, so that's more.
It is true. If you have the OG, you're going to be able to mint more of the dragon handlers than if you don't have the OG role.
And so. For people that might not know about the Dragon Guild, one of the things about it is that every NFT that they mint is attached to a piece of TCG property, ranging from silver to gold to platinum.
Hey, so, what's that? What's the website for Dragon Guild? So
DragonGuildNFT.com.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, yeah.
Check out Matt Cosson's awesome artwork.
Mm-hmm.
Looking good.
Thank you, Matt. Thank you.
Did you do the colors for this, Matt? Matt, did you do the colors?
Yep, nice. Everything from, yeah.
Oh, wow. Matt.
Love it.
Thanks, man. I'm excited. It's fun. It's fun working with these guys. We're having a blast. It's hard work, but it's definitely worth it. I'm getting excited seeing all the messages. My Twitter's blowing up. I'm getting messages like 20 every other minute. It's like, what the?
Oh, yeah?
Go through them all. Not private messages, but, you know, the alerts and everything, so.
Let me know when you get someone sending you the picture of the dragon handler tattooed on their body.
Oh yeah,
because that's
that would be wild. Time.
Yeah, it'll happen for sure.
That'll be wild.
Okay, right. So Dragon Guild whitelist OG passes and the quick prize summary. So, do you have the picture of the prizes, Mike?
One moment, please.
Okay.
So, where is that on the?
Oh, I've tweeted it. It's go look on our Twitter. I mean, I've got
the tweeters.
Go look on the Twitter. So basically, this part of the whole me spiel talking is to give people who wanted time to enter the Discord giveaway to do it because you've got six more minutes. Yeah, that's got. Well, I mean, that's one that works. But I changed that. There's a new one now.
All right, where's that?
Find a better one. No, that's the same one. Okay. Anyways, well, I can
always
say
nag.
I know. What are you even? Oh, you're just scrolling down your feed. No.
All right.
I guess we could say at this point in time, if you're not following us on Twitter, go to that one's perfect.
All right, there we go. See, I was just building up the expectation.
That's right. Go to Funky Monkey Frat House. Funky Monkey FH is our Twitter handle and our Instagram handle. Deploy Starship is Deploy Starship all over the place, so that's easy to remember. Cyber Hornets is Cyber Hornets. Okay.
My deepest apologies.
That's okay. So we'll so the prizes here, we'll go over them quickly. The Genesis custom draws are going to be for a Toga Monkey, as well as an Animus. And then the collection, the draws for everybody. You've got a chance to win a Ape Hornet, which is entirely appropriate for Funky Monkeys. We have a Meta Bounty Hunter. We have a TCG Silver Plot. We have what I have noted here as a priceless Madams and Monsters NFT, because you cannot buy these anywhere. Zach unlisted them. It's going to be ridiculously overpowered in the NFT game he's launching. And yeah, so you can't buy these. I was like, Zach, I need one to give away.
And I was like, okay.
He did not. Yeah, it was back and forth. I was offering firstborn children. It was nice. Then we have ETH Towers. Yeah, an ETH Tower apartment. Then we have the first ever to be given away to be received metallic Club 101 Dragon, Gold Dragon. So we'll go into more of these in depth, and a 251 Bad Monkey, which has absolutely zero utility and just looks cool, which is not what we usually do around here. So that's why it's really cool. And it comes with one ETH liquid Ethereum,
which is actually cooler, but
which is cooler and is also a royalty reshare.
That's right.
From the project, because one of the things that we do is quarterly frat parties where we give away part of the royalties.
This is correct. All right. How much tax on priceless? Well, that's the great thing about things that are priceless. You don't have to pay tax because the price is
priceless.
Less. I don't
know. Dang.
Okay.
Well, Zach, okay, you set a price on it. You want them to pay taxes on it?
Duh. We won't know yet. The market dictates price, and it's off the market.
Yeah. Whatever the floor is, if there's a floor price.
Don't give tax advice, Zach.
Nope.
You're not eligible to do that. Come on now.
Nope. I am not liable.
Hey, I see Paul is in. Paul's in the Discord. He needs a link. Paul PCG is in the Discord. And it's 7:27. So in 3 minutes, the giveaway bot's going to assign a frat monkey to someone,
and
they will get into the lottery to win one of these prizes. Which, the value I calculated was $15,000 for all of this, and that's. And that's a lower value than what's actually there. That was me rounding down.
Excellent. So we just say over 15,000 because that sounds nice. All right. So we're waiting until how long until the TikTok ticks down and
the TikTok dance? Yeah, it's 2 minutes. It's not going to be at 6:30 your time. But the next thing on the itinerary is the State of the Monkey address. But while we're waiting, why don't we give away some more Starship stuff? Because we've got a lot of Starship stuff to give away.
Let's do.
So,
put something Starship-y on the screen. But I mean, we could just do this too.
Okay. Well, let's.
The size of your head.
It's a huge head.
Huge head.
Oh, he'll be crying himself to sleep tonight on his.
I can't do it. Pillow.
Sure, he can get through doorways.
You're zoomed in. Okay, they're piercing my soul now, bro. That's too much. That's too much.
This look of love and admiration. So let's see. Post wax wallet addresses in our Discord, and I'm gonna pick one. I'm gonna pick some, and I'll send some prizes. Let's see.
Yeah, and the Discord should be in the description. I believe
discord.gg/fmfh. We've got too many Matts in here. I can't just Matt Albright. Do you have a nickname? Do you have a Starship name?
Just call me Starship. I like that.
Mr. Starship.
Star-Lord.
Okay, so Mr. Starship, Lady Maria is going to be getting a pack. What kind of pack should she get?
I love Lady Maria. She's awesome.
Do we have extended packs? Do we have standard packs?
What
do we
have? I have Unity standard packs, Phase 2 Unity standard packs. I have Phase 2 Unity sticker packs, and I have Phase 2 Unity Catalyst packs.
Do the standard pack.
Standard pack it is.
Yeah.
Okay, and we'll do one more. What kind of pack should I give this undecided person?
The Catalyst pack.
Catalyst, yeah. Do the okay. Catalyst.
Okay, we are doing Catalyst for the next name I pick out, which is Ace Morningstar. Congratulations, Ace Morningstar. That's, I like that name. That Ace Morningstar, you have won yourself a Catalyst pack.
Pull a mythic.
Do May it. The odds be ever in your favor.
Nice.
And it's now 7:30 here in Mountain Time. So it's 6:30. It so let's go check out this giveaway.
Right. For me.
Can I do it on the screen so everybody can see it?
Well, you can sure. go look. I mean, it's just it's going to we're just gonna go and look and see if it's revealed in the giveaway section.
Yeah. So I'll put that on screen and then we'll just stare at it. Ooh. Until it's actually
organized. It's either Stefan Louis or Stefan Louis. You've won a Funky Monkey Frat House number 1147 Greek Life and a 1 of 10 rare limited edition Q1 quarterly Frat Party 2022 event NFT.
Let's go.
Nice. Good job. Nice.
Let's go.
And welcome, Alex. Yeah. Hello.
What's up, guys?
What's up, Alex?
Just kind of hanging out, getting some stuff done, trying to get my voice back. What you doing?
We're giving away stuff. What did we just give away?
We just gave away. Well, okay. So do you want to? We just gave away a funky monkey, a Greek monkey, and I'm gonna get you the address so you can send it to them. And
I'm not gonna do it while gas is this high. Gas is like $4 billion right now.
Okay, so what we'll do is this: if that monkey gets drawn, the prize will still be going to them later.
Well, yeah. I mean, I'm just because it's because
I understand.
Ape. All right. So for those who don't know, Bored Ape Yacht Club launched their land sale for their metaverse at the same time we launched this show. So the gas price is like super crazy insane right now. So,
it's only 7,627 way. Come on now. That's like $400 a transaction. That's not shit, bro.
What is that in USD?
There was a mathematic equation someone sent me. Hold on. Let me see.
So there's no way I know how much way is.
So, yeah, I have no idea about that. I just look at the dollar amount, and it's ridiculous.
It has to do with zeros. He sent me an equation that you can punch in, and it's basically everything's just like a zero. So if you just do Gwei and then add in like the zeros and then take that away from how many Gwei are in like an ETH, then you just get the
answer. Yeah, okay, you lost me.
I want a robot.
When he was explaining it to me, I was like, what are you talking about? And then
what
he
is
was
this, like quantum physics?
No, he put it on his screen, and he was like, look at this equation. He punched it out, put the next line, and he was like, do you see the zeros? And I'm like, yeah. And he's like, okay, if Gwei's at this, it's this, and then just times that by the ETH price, there's your answer. So, hold on.
You know, anyone, you can just go to a
that's thing all simple tell you.
Yeah, anyone who says we don't know how to party, I mean,
I'm glad this is a good one, guys.
Later on, we're going to talk about gas prices and Gwei.
Anyway, everyone to the stream, our TCG official representative, Alex Nays, TCG business manager. What's your
thing, emperor? You know, whatever.
Yeah.
Business Alex. Emperor.
Something or other.
Yeah, I don't really got a voice, so I can't talk too much, but yeah, I wanted to hang out at least a little bit.
Right, well,
and boy, man, you guys, you know how to party.
That's right. Yeah. Ain't no party here, like a funky monkey
since
party.
Alex is here, and I don't know how long his voice is going to last. Let's take a brief respite from what we're doing so Alex can tell us about the Metaverse Expo 2022.
Ooh.
Oh, you mean at Vegas?
Yeah.
Oh, it's in Vegas.
Yeah, so we're hosting. It was gonna be a like sponsored small little thing, and it's kind of gone away from being a small little thing into a huge freaking thing because we rented out the Las Vegas Convention Center, so it's like 200,000 square foot build is freaking enormous. So if anybody like goes to conventions, I was just at the Bitcoin convention in Miami, which is huge, and the place that we rented out is bigger than that. So. We're gonna do some stuff and some things. The idea is just to hang out with a bunch of people we love and care about, get a bunch of really cool speakers, get some cool headlines, and just enjoy each other in Vegas. And so we're gonna have a huge booth. By that point, we're gonna be dropping some pretty large things about TCG World. So we're gonna have some big projections. We're gonna have a bunch of computers so people can log in and do stuff.
It's going to be a pretty fun expo. And Mike will be there. Buzz will be there. It's just going to be a really, really good time. So that's going to be in mid-July. And we're going to come out with a bunch of information on all the extra little juicy details here in the next couple of weeks. But yeah, it's just going to be convention after convention. And then Mike and I are going to go hang out after the convention.
In San Diego.
In San Diego at Comic-Con. Yep. So, okay. And then I have four conventions I'm going to this month. I got to leave next week. So it's going to be a little wild summer.
There's something we're going to be doing that we're not technically allowed to announce until 2 weeks before the con for some stupid reason.
Nobody knows. So,
no one knows anything.
Nobody's
watching nothing.
Well, Alex, when you're in San Diego, Mike knows a good burger place you can go to with him.
That's in La Jolla, bro.
But they have more locations.
Is it McDonald's?
I'm really hoping that TCG
that's where he took me.
Sounds like a place that he'd take you to.
It's a special one in Japantown. They call it Makodunarudo. It's really, really special.
What's the name of it again? Say it again.
Makodunarudo.
And it's a burger place?
That's how they pronounce McDonald's in Japan.
McDonald's. I love
it. I love watching commercials like Makodunarudo. It's cool.
I know. It's like the SpongeBob.
I'm talking fried chicken.
We party. The
SpongeBob SquarePants. Yeah.
Anyways, SDCC is usually completely sold out, but I'm doing everything I can to see if we can get a TCG booth there and be the first representatives of Metaverse in the biggest pop culture convention on the planet. So that would be really excellent, but don't know yet. We'll have to find out. I'm pulling every string I got.
Definitely want Estana as many of you there. I mean, I could see Buzz on chat. I see Matt from Starship. We want to get together with all our partners, and you guys can all hang out with all of us in person. I think that's so cool. Get a bunch of fun celebrities, headliner acts, some really cool, like, high-level speakers, which we're working on right now, getting, like, some really good, like, speaker topics and people to come down. And so, yeah, it's going to be a really fun event. I, for sure, have never put on anything like this before, so it'll be a lot of new experiences for all of us, but... it's going to be just so freaking fun. So hopefully as many of you possibly can be there, and we'd love to all hang out.
I'm excited to go.
That's going to be a real party.
Yeah. Awesome. You should come. You should come out to Vegas.
I would like to. I would definitely like to.
Hope we like all wake up one morning and have like Mike Tyson's tiger in our hotel.
Saturday for my birthday. That Saturday is my birthday. So that Saturday.
Is it really?
Saturday, nice. July 9th is my birthday. So
don't you also have a baby due?
On the 24th. So yeah, hopefully she doesn't come early because I won't be able to make Vegas then.
Yeah, I thought you were, because I won't be there.
Yeah.
right now the girlfriend's gonna come, and I was like, yo, I mean, we talked about it. The doctor said we could go, and worst case scenario, he was like, you better call ahead to some, you know, doctors over there, because there's a chance you could have a Vegas baby. And I was like,
name the
birth certificate part is a bit of a pain because you have to get it from Vegas, and technically she's born there, but. Besides that, I'm like, you know, it's the last chance we have to go somewhere.
At the Little White Chapel, it's like, man, they don't make you jump through any hoops to do things like that over there. So,
is that the one where the fake Elvis marries you?
No. But dude, it's funny. You go in there and they have all these pictures of the celebrity weddings they've had from like celebrities that just like randomly went into, you know. I'm getting married in Vegas this weekend because I've had way too much to drink.
How many people go to Vegas and return with a baby?
Yeah.
I hope if you go to Vegas with a baby, you come back with the baby.
But but if you go without, you're like, come back with a baby.
All right. What's on the schedule?
Oh, well, next on the schedule
this
is
a little detour. Thank you, Alec.
Yeah, you're welcome. Yeah, I'm just going to hang out with you guys.
Right on.
Next on the schedule is the State of the Frat address, Mike.
Oh, the State of the Frat is strong.
Lame.
All right, next topic. Basically, that one's covered. We're good. Next
basically,
one.
This is where I wrote in a section where it's like, this is an opportunity for Mike to talk about what we've been through, where we, you know, the past quarter, the struggles, the successes.
What have I done?
What does our project look like?
What do you do?
Launch chads.
I don't know where to start. There's so much going on.
Because there's people here who don't know the project.
You didn't set up a teleprompter for him?
I know,
for this,
I know. Like, where's the
I wrote it on my chest,
true,
but I realized I'm on camera now.
True international pressure.
All right. Well, the state of the frat, we're going to go through here. What do we got? We're at, I mean, you already listed the, where the prices are, the floor prices for everything. Floor price for the frat collection is 0.15. We've only got six prior to the 0.25, which should be the base price, because coming up very soon, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm going to show this, even though I'm probably not supposed to.
No, at the end of the state of the frat address segues into crypto chads. So you're really in the
ballpark. You didn't even tell me what the state of frat address. Now you tell me there's a whole plan.
You didn't get the itinerary for the
segue.
Whole thing.
That's the segue. Okay. So as far
because
as
that's where we're from, where we're going.
This feels like a frat house.
Yep.
This is the frat house. Here we are.
Someone had too many beers and forgot to pass on the notes.
My dog ate my notes.
I sent them at least two different places.
You're just reading it. I didn't read the notes. I just wanted them to be there.
They're there. It's like a safety blanket.
Okay. Well, just crutch me as I hobble through this.
You're doing great.
All right. So we're doing very well. We are double the mint price for the and my son's here. So the mint price obviously was 0.0777 for the Greek life, and the floor price is now double that at 0.15. And as I was saying, anything below 0.25, I think is a discount because of the thing I'm not supposed to mention till the end of this.
So very difficult. Okay. How about, you know, there's a lot of people here from Starship. There's a lot of people here from TCG who maybe don't know that much about the frat. So why did you create the frat house? What is this about?
Hi, my name is Mike Espinosa.
Who are you?
I'm 30 years.
There are
comic vet. You can tell by the Joker poking out of my door that I am a comic book artist. This is all my art. This is Injustice, the Meg. I've got Batman stuff and just my arm hurts. I've got 30 years worth of comic book industry behind me, and now I do NFTs and I work for TCG as a lore and creature creator, and I'm just, my whole life is now subsumed by crypto and all of its adjunct sections of business, and this is where I want to make my home for the rest of my natural born life. I had a vision 3 years ago to do a multimedia company, and it seems like this is all just stepping stones on the path to that road, and it's a great glorious thing, and I'm just so happy to be here and be part of this and have all these great partners and associations. So I came from the Pluto Alliance. I started working with BitBoy Crypto. I did some of his projects. Ultimately, I did Pluto Alliance. And then I went from Pluto Alliance and started my own fractionalized NFT collection, the Funky Monkey Frat House, which is everything around you here. We started out wanting to do a 10,000 collection. We had to create a whole new contract. My devs created a whole new contract that allowed you to pause the collection and swap out art, because I wanted to do different segments of one whole collection. So the first 1,000 was the Toga Monkeys. And I kind of explained earlier how that kind of got off to a bumpy little start, but we ended up selling out the Toga Monkeys in about a day. And then we allowed time to go to pass. And then we were going to launch the Greek Life collection, which was going to be 8,000 Funky Monkeys, all with, like, you know, Greek life stuff, like the basically it's all based on Animal House, right? So I took the Animal House kind of through line with the Toga Party, the Greek Life, and then the Pirate Parade, and I'm like, that's how I want to frame my storyline for this collection.
And I ended up doing the smartest thing on earth, which was launching the Greek Life Party on the day of the highest gas prices in the history of Ethereum, I think. And so it was really silly because a bunch of these other collections were like, yeah, we're canceling our launch, or we're postponing our launch because these gas prices are impossible. And I'm like, not me. I'm too smart. Yep. And so we ran into a bit of a stall out. I've been in crypto for 5 years. So my it's been drilled into my head. Bears are for building, right? And so I stopped and I decided, rather than pushing sales, I'm just going to pull back on that. I'm going to let the market chill out. And I am going to build utility, which is how I ended up with Starship. Because one of the first things we did is some of the people in my community were really getting into Starship. And one of them said, I can't remember who, it was probably Rusty. He's like, man, you need to talk to these guys about getting a space station. And I was like, this is utility. So we would go, I went to Starship, had the meeting, bought a space station so that we could take the revenue, the kyanite, from the space station and share it with the monkey holders. And so that, and then, the creation of the crypto chads, which I'm not supposed to talk about. Anyways, I just wanted to keep adding utility to the community to the point where you'd have to be brain dead not to want to own a monkey, right? Like, not just, I'm not trying to hype and just get everybody to want to buy the monkeys. I want the monkeys to have an intrinsic value and utility so that people, and this is what happens, right, Jordan? People come into the chat, like they might, not the chat, the Discord, they just kind of stumble in and they're like, what is this? And then our very, very helpful monkeys in the chat will explain all of the utility that we have built up over this time. And 99% of the time, they're like, how do I get one? Because it's the utility and the community. It's such a great community. So positive and uplifting and helpful. It's really, now there's two Alex Nazes now. That's weird.
Double the Naze, double your fun.
Double the Naze.
And prepare for double.
So, what other utility? And then part of the frat is that as a 30-year industry vet for comics, I have a bunch of great, fantastic artist friends who are starving because comics are a terrible place to try to make a living. And so I've grown sort of a reputation in the space in the crypto space, the NFT space. And so regularly people come to me wanting me to work with them. And I just don't have the bandwidth for that anymore. I've tied my ship to TCG. I work with Metal Labs Group. And then I'm trying to do my own stuff at the same time. And so I cannot take on any other projects, per se, unless it's my project and it's future stuff. Anyways.
I'm just drinking mate. Don't mind
what me. I'm doing. You be glad.
It's supposed to be a frat party. Aren't you supposed to have a beer?
Yeah.
Yeah. Mate, beer.
What do you got? Come on, Mike.
This is iced tea.
I thought it was special whiskey and Coke.
No, I'll get to the Jack later. But
I mean, yeah.
I've got Texas IP. Texas IPA.
I got a PBR. That's what my monkey had in the picture. So I had to get one.
IPA makes me want to puke. How can you drink that
stuff? I like how Starship is on brand.
Pretty bad.
I got some hot lemon tea with honey.
You are a badass.
Alex, that's the way to do it. Alex, talk about a real frat house drink, right?
I know.
Alex, I'll send you some Oregon honey, bro. I've got some.
I know. I need some.
It's got like the pollen that helps you.
I know. My poor pathetic voice.
Anyways, I'm going to be right back. I got to run downstairs and help the GF real quick.
All right, bro. I was actually just going to talk about you.
Just go.
I thought you were going to say, oh, I'm just about ready to talk about your GF.
Well, now I got to stay. I'm still switching over to my mobile phone.
How different people, Buzz included, has come to me and said, hey, you know, we'd love to work with you and get some stuff done. And like, so I helped Buzz put together a whole team to create his comic book. And then I also helped him with another artist for the Animus project, Elliot Fernandez. And so time after time, I think I've gotten 5 or 6 gigs set up for various artists in what we call the guest artist section, because I think of this as an artist incubator space, where I can, like I said, bring my friends from the, you know, starvation diet comic book industry.
I've been eating better.
Before I walk away for 5 minutes?
Yeah.
Basically, like, Mike, I got in touch with him through Pluto Alliance, and then we met, developed a little bit of a relationship, moved to Cyber Hornets myself, and then, you know, I hit him up, and I was like, yo, I know you know some artists, and I have to say, Mike is really about bringing in artists in the space and helping them, because... You know, the overall consensus is, like, the people that work for Marvel and DC and these other big name companies, they don't really make what they should. And I don't think they really get appreciated how they should. Mm-hmm. And so I think bridging them into the space, you're bringing in really talented artists. You're helping teach them. There's a little bit of, I guess, learning curve. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
The anchoring, the traits, everything else that goes into. Separating everything into files, you know, the whole process with everything. But, you know, and Mike, literally, like, when we were working with some artists for Cyber Hornets, Mike went in and he spent his own time, like, and he helped walk these guys through, you know, the different processes to get them to where we needed to have the art be. And it came out great.
Yeah, thank you. And, Matt's going through that right now.
And that's really the reason, part of the reason with making Funky Monkey Frat House Studio and Studio Artists, right? That you're helping provide this service and provide a good professional level of art and fair wages and yeah, I think this is one of the most exciting parts of Web3, that we're going to see creators being able to actually. They could get good value on their artistry.
And it's not just that. This is something that I kind of think of often is that as we are going directly to the collectors out there, we're building our own communities. We're building our own bulwark against the cancel culture, right? Because, you know, if I got my community behind me, nobody can come after me and try to cancel me from my community, right? The people who I've built friendships and relationships with and who for whom I have provided direct
benefit, value.
Yeah, value.
Relationship.
There you go. So, yeah. That's a really powerful tool in this day and age. You know, Elon Musk can't come save us all.
He can save me.
You can see me any day,
Elon. Hello.
Yeah. So, as far as that, yeah, the state of the frat. I mean, everything is going great. The monkeys are all sold out for what we have available, and we're just continuing to build relationships and continuing to build future projects. Stuff that we can talk about, stuff that we cannot talk about just yet. I was on the phone with my new partner on this other adventure that I'm that Jordan knows about, but not too many other people know. Zach knows a little bit, but I can't, I won't, because I asked him, like, is there anything I can talk about? He's like, probably not a good idea just yet. I'm not gonna, Jordan. Relax.
Look at the yelling monkey.
But it's big. Zach, tell him how big it is. No, don't tell him. All right. It's
it's minuscule.
Mike hasn't told anyone watching this, Mike hasn't told a single person.
I'm like that meme of the guy. I can't remember that.
Anyways, will be discussing. I'm getting questions about Chad's and stuff, so we will be answering some Chad questions very soon.
Yeah. So, anything else, or can we go to the Chads? Because that's
well, really I think. Yeah, I think you did a great job, and I think that's a great segue into the launch Chads and Rads and utility and what that's about, which leads right into the crypto chat expansion.
Okay. So part of the utility that I wanted to bring to the Funky Monkeys was Preston Winters for $10 says, talk about it. No one is listening. Thank you. No. So, prior to my making the Funky Monkey collection, I had made a collection of Chads that I showed to Justin over at BitBoy, and he's like, that's going to do really well. He's like, you want to do that with us? And I'm like, sure, but we were in the middle of Pluto Alliance and all this stuff. So I just kind of took it and I put it to the side, and then I started developing the Funky Monkeys. Oddly enough, that was the third collection that I'd done of my own. I also have some dragons, but that's totally tangential and doesn't matter. Anyways, so I wanted to mint the Chads and give them to all of the monkeys as like a utility, as a gift, right? But then I'm like, well, there's no purpose in just giving somebody. I don't want to just have another collection that has no actual utility. At the time, I don't know how many of you guys know what launch pads are, but launch pads are basically crowdfunded venture capitalist funding for IDOs, which is like initial coin offerings or tokens that are coming up for sale from new companies. And so this IDO here, I should probably blow myself up again. The thing is about IDOs and launch pads is Americans aren't offered these services because the SEC can't guarantee any consumer protections from people who want to invest their money into things that aren't. I don't know. It's how the SEC keeps rich people rich and poor people poor. They don't want poor people to invest in things that can make their money, you know, they're risky, but still. So you have to be an accredited investor to do that. But if you're, say, a German citizen, you have no problem doing this sort of thing. So my nephew is a German citizen in Germany. And so I worked out a deal with him where I would just stake stuff for him and he could make these investments. And anyways, long story short, one of these things, we turned $100 into $40,000 literally overnight. And I'm like, that's utility. I'm like, that's something. If you could do that for, you know, the community and for your NFTs and whatnot. So anyways, we kind of went through all the legalities and all the stuff and ended up with this UK corporation that is going to handle everything. So that's completely legal and has nothing to do with when you buy a Chad. Well, okay. The initial idea was giving the Chads away, but now we've kind of changed all that stuff and I don't really get too much into it. Rad says DWP. That's right. They're called random airdrops. This is, we're coming to it. DW, relax. So what we're doing is we're loaning money to this UK corporation. The UK corporation then stakes into all these different launch pads, gets the maximum allocation of the IDO tokens for each of these upcoming new token drops, and then sprinkles them all like magic pixie dust into the wallets of everybody that owns a Chad. We started this with the test project, the launch Chads. It was 1,000 launch Chads at 0.1 ETH each. We sold all those. We funded all of these launch pads. And so far, it's done really well. Even in this bear market, all of the different launch chads, the average aggregate is 300%, right? I think if I check the last one. So, but man, I'm like, what happens during alt season, right? When usually it's like these little, I don't know, if, I can't promise anything, any of these are going to be worth anything, right? But this is the way alts are. It's some of them, for whatever reason, you know, obviously it's the better alts have staying power and all that stuff, but some of these will just hit and go from, you know, not everything's a Dogecoin. I'm not looking at Dogecoin, but some of these things will 1,000x. Well, okay, I can't say they will. There's no.
No, some things have. Some in things the past. Have.
Yeah. You can't say it won't.
No, and but I can't say they won't. No, and what it is like if you're an individual and you, even if you have the means to do this in the nation you're in, you know, it costs quite a bit to get into one of them.
Yeah.
And this is like way back in the day with when they were like merchant vessels doing the spice trade. You know, the people who had the money would buy 1/10 of 10 different ships, and because they would diversify the risk, because some of those ships aren't going to make it back. Yeah. And so basically, this allows people to get into to get into an access system where there's. Where there are IDOs descending from above, from the Chad Utility Project up in the sky, the CUP.
Yeah.
The launch Chads, the proceeds from that went to the UK corporation, and then the Chad Utility Project in the sky, the CUP, drops the IDO tokens into the wallets of people who hold Launch Chads or Frat Monkeys or Genesis Customs, because those NFT collections in our project get that utility. And we have Frat a whole...
Frat Monkeys don't.
Oh no, they don't, do they? They get the Chads. They get the.
They get. They're gonna get. Yeah, they get the Chads. This is where we're coming.
Oh my!
Right. So the Frat Monkeys. If you own a Frat Monkey before the Chad launch, you will get a Chad for free. When the Chads launch, which is coming up soon, next month. And this is, by the way, going to be marketed and promoted by Meta Labs Group, which marketed and promoted Meta Bounty Hunters, which did from zero web presence to selling $17 million worth of NFTs in less than 7 weeks. These are the guys that are marketing the crypto chads.
I think they were actually a sponsor at one of the conventions in Miami, too.
Yes, yeah, they were. That's right. NFT Miami was sponsored by them.
Yep, NFT Miami, yep.
Yeah, so they're going to be sponsoring these. That's the price on these is going to be 0.25 ETH. Now, once again, look at where we are with the Funky Monkeys. Where are they? There are still
refresh.
Six monkeys, less than 0.25. So plus you will the get the monkeys... Pool. And the chads, because each of these, when you own them in your wallet, comes with a chad. So not financial advice. That's right, Flipburger. But I consider these six on a discount because it's less than you'll get them for the chads. And I really do think with the marketing behind these things will sell very quickly. It's like a third of the price of the Meta Bounty Hunters. And I think it's the best utility ever of... in the whole NFT world. So
and for those who are a part of the project as well, who've been around for a while, what we've announced is that the launch chads that are already existing that launched the cup into the sky, they cost 0.1 ETH. When the crypto chads mint out, there will be a buyback. So
yeah,
they'll
yeah,
be
yeah.
getting so every launch chad every holder of a launch chad will get 0.1 ETH for that launch chad. So that's being bought back. And then,
well, let me explain why I felt that was necessary is because the initial launch chads were getting 25% of all of the token airdrops, right? Because at the time we were just going to give away the chads. They're just going to give away. So it's like, if the chads get 25%, then you get a free chad, you get free airdrops, but it's not much. Now that the crypto chads will be funding to the tune of millions of dollars these different launch pads and other possible investments or other places we could put our money to bring more utility and more utility to the chads, they have the lion's share of the investment. I can't use the word investment, but they're the lion's share. And so rather than just saying, well, sorry, launch chads, I'm just cutting off your whatever, I'm just going to buy out their previous
purchase.
So everybody that paid their 0.1 for the launch chad and has been holding on to them, now your launch chad is free. Right? Anybody that wants to go to buy a launch chad on Immutable X right now and it's 0.2, then you could buy that and it's 50% off because you're going to get 0.1 ETH back. So I thought it was important. I always try to go a little bit beyond what rational people would probably do to make things fair, because I just want to encourage the community to always think, you know, I'm looking out for them. We're in this together. We're going to make it, you know, all the typical stuff.
To add on to that, like, actually, we've just been going to back-to-back conventions and there's like 50,000 NFT projects there and they all claim that they're doing something revolutionary or they got some crazy amounts of utility. And I do try to talk to a lot of them because I'm a, you know, leave no stone unturned type guy. But as I'm talking to them, it's just like when we get right down to the brass tacks, like, it's the same as utilities as like everybody else. Like, there's nothing new, nothing exciting. And I think as NFTs start becoming more rational, because it's been a little bit of an irrational market for a little bit, I think a lot of the ones that have a ton of utility and have a ton of current and future utility going to add on to it, like, I think that's what people are going to be really drawn and attracted to. And so we're big fans of the Funky Monkey Frat House for that reason. It's just the not only the quality of art, but the backing and the utilities and everything behind it. So yeah, are you sending me the $20 to say that now or later?
It's in your PayPal, bro.
Okay, good. But seriously, yeah, I'm really impressed with you guys. You guys do such a good job, and yeah, we're proud to be partners with you.
Thanks, Alex. We appreciate it, man. I couldn't be more stoked to be part of CCG. You know that. I say it every time I'm on your show. So. And then Paul, your partner in crime there, says, I need a diagram of all this. So many chads and monkeys and starships and TCGs and dragon gills and cyber harness and frat launch and chai. Okay. Yeah, it does get, you know, it's not a simple thing because there is so much and each project does have its own utility. And I'm constantly trying to add utility. And some of you guys might be saying, okay, well, great. After the crypto chads comes out and I get my free thing, I can dump my monkey. Don't dump your monkey. I've got a really fun and I'm not going to say
that's okay. No, it's
very rewarding idea for a really great way to move the monkeys once the pirates are sold out.
I would say, Mike, that you have shown a strong track record of adding utility to the project and to where things are lower, lifting it up higher. And that even after the crypto chads have been dealt out from the frat monkeys are not going to be left behind because they're the core collection of the whole project. They're like the trunk of the tree. And you, that needs to be strong. Otherwise the structure collapses. So, you know, they're not going to be left behind.
Yeah, you won't be able to play the special Monkey Frat House level if you won't have one. So,
what?
We'll get to that when we get to the Madams and Monsters.
Oh man,
that's a teaser. Just wait. I was just giving away some wax, some Starship prizes in the chat, and I'll do it again later in the YouTube
or maybe. I'm just going to scroll through this. This is not the final site, but they are building the. They sent me three different versions of the website to see what I wanted to do. And this is the one I just fell in love with. So I'm just going to scroll through it so you see how cool Meta Labs is making my freaking.
And so ballpark for this May, early May, mid-May, late May, May?
I was trying to get a launch date like set in stone, but I couldn't get it before the stream. So as soon as I find out, we will go. I wanted to be launched by this week, but I think we need some marketing time first. So, although I'll tell you what, man, like I said, Meta Bounty Hunters, they went from zero and launched in 3 weeks, and their first day they made like $4 or $5 million. So, It could be so, that. Those guys know what they're doing.
I'm going to guess there's a couple things we could say. I mean, I haven't talked about this before, but I'm guessing that Genesis Customs holders will get whitelist of some capacity.
Genesis Customs holders. Also, for those who are new, there's another smaller collection. It's going to be maxed out at 502. But you'll be able to order a custom image, a custom. Here, let me open it up. Customs. A custom monkey for the Frat collection. And these customs, they were the genesis of this entire line. I started doing these before anything else, and then I started bringing in my artist friends to be guest artists on these projects, on these customs as well. And so the floor price here, you can buy one of these on the floor for like 0.42, 0.44. But if you want to order one custom made, it's 0.5 ETH from a guest artist. It's 2 ETH from me. So, and it's just because I'm just too bloody busy to take time out to do one of these for anything less. So
mine are animated.
And that's right. Let's find some animated ones here.
Search by most recently created.
Yeah. There's only 251. I'll just scroll through. There's one.
Zach, you animated it.
There's Rusty's. Yeah. Yeah, there's Rusty's.
That's Rusty's.
Yeah. Wow. So
I did it all night. It's cool.
Show Zach. Off. That is awesome.
Yeah. So anyways, that's the customs. Just another collection but they get white lists, and they are quite expensive, but trust me, when you know what's coming over the next 3 months, you're gonna be like, why don't I have a custom? You
how get much white are listed. They Mike,
I told you they're 0.5 ETH or 2 ETH from me,
the so, big monkey.
But they get white list to every Frat House project and every Frat House related project. So like when I have one of my artists go do work like Matt, right, for Dragon Guild, part of the deal before, you know, I even negotiate a price for these guys is I'm like, we need a whitelist for the custom monkeys, for the custom Genesis holders. And there, it's what it is. So when I tell you what the projects we have coming up are, you're going to really, really want to be on those whitelists. I can't say anything. Jordan. I can't say anything, Jordan.
Yes. No. sorry. I'm getting messages. I'm multitasking. So.
All right. Anyways, that's the cool website. I can't wait for this thing to launch. I'm really looking forward to it.
I also liked how it has the Delta Chimp NFT being utilized in the launch here, which is also on the bottom of the Starship station. And so, you know, this is something that. It's another fractionalized NFT that exists out there that we're tying into different things throughout the projects.
That's right. All right. And we have now here with us Grandpa, but I don't know which grandpa it is. There's so many grandpas in this space.
Well, I think it's probably Grandpa from Starship.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So if you don't know, there's a collection called Grandpa Degenerate Grandpas.
Oh,
and so,
okay.
Like, all these people have grandpa as their name, and I'm like,
there's a grandpa party club too.
Grandpa party. Oh, okay. Well, there you go. It just
keeps... that grandpa won like I think he won like a platinum plot with us in a giveaway.
Yes, he did, and he
I remember because he's only
off my back because I used his number. And I bought like 50 plots.
I like that. He's on remember camera. Giving a shout out on the AMA to a grandpa. So I think it's the same guy.
Grandpa, did you win?
Boris.
Have you won TCG? That was other grandpa. No, it was grandpa.
Yeah. Boris. Oh, that was other grandpa. Yeah.
That was not Grandpa Starship.
Yeah. Grandpa Starship, you want to come in and introduce yourself? Or not? You're muted. And you're not saying anything.
Grandpa Boris is in Starship, though. Don't they have a station?
I don't know.
Hey, guys.
Or not.
And you're not saying anything.
Boris is in Starship, though. Don't they have a station?
Oh, there's the delay.
Oh, you're watching YouTube. You need to turn your YouTube off.
Mute the YouTube. This is the most, that was the most rambunctious part of this party yet.
I heard myself four times, so.
All right, Grandpa, you have to turn your YouTube off and use the volume from your StreamYard.
Grandpa. I love how you're explaining tech to Grandpa.
Cheers, Rob.
I got the audio figured out on the stream platform.
Okay. Welcome.
Welcome.
So, yeah, thanks for having me. It's good to be here. I got to reposition my camera here. There we go. How's everybody doing tonight?
You're looking good, Brandon.
Doing good.
Doing well. Feeling good, trying to do well.
You don't look like a grandpa at all.
I am a grandpa.
Wow, that's unbelievable.
I'm old enough to be. I just, none of my kids have. That's all right. Now it's a potty, says Justin. All right. Grandpa, do you want to say anything as you have just arrived?
You know, just want to give you guys a shout out for everything you guys have done in coordination with our project. And you know, we've been trying to do the same for you guys. I'm you know, a holder of a monkey, and I'm super excited for what you guys have coming up, and, you know, I'm happy to be a part of the project.
Awesome. Thank you, man. Yeah, we're back. Glad to be part of Starship. And Robert.
Dragon Guild in the house.
Hey, guys. What's happening?
What's up?
Going all right. How about you?
We're just partying.
I'm doing great. I'm repping Matt's artwork behind me.
Good choice.
Hey, Robert. Hey.
Good to see you, man. Did you want to take a second and talk about Dragon Guild?
Yeah. So it's an NFT project. We're building a guild, basically taking community, making the best community we can make. And I don't know if you guys knew or not, but we spent $4.6 million buying land in TCG World, and it's a mix of platinum and silver and gold lots, and also a big commercial lot, 256 meters, I guess you say, by 256. And we're making the NFT, and then we're going to merge it with the land, and we're building a commercial lot out in TCG World, and we're making three guild buildings for the community. They can put on their own land, and each individual NFT, which we're going to be minting at, should be approximately $750, will come with a plot of land, and it'll be kind of random where you'll get a silver or gold or a platinum lot. And my partner let out the bag yesterday that we have at least 1% platinum lots. So that's a pretty big little lottery along with it. So
yeah, you want to slide that one on over to me.
Yeah, exactly. Everybody's like, I want the one with the platinum lot. I said, well, random, just minute.
But yeah, I wanted to say that was amazing. When I heard that was going to be your utility, Alex was talking about all these other projects, their utilities kind of just a ho-hum. When I heard you were doing that, I was like, why didn't I think of that? That's genius.
Yeah, it's funny because, you know, Jay and I've been talking about it for months, and we came up with this idea, I think probably back in December. And started like really, you know, thinking about how it was going to work and what we were going to do and how to do it. And we were both like under the secret triangle of silence. We couldn't even tell our, you know, friends or family or anybody. We were just like, you better not tell anybody, because everybody that finds out about it will want to do it. And then they'll be like so many other people doing it, and we want to make sure that we can do it.
And I'll tell you what, dude, that's another fantastic reason not to do the, and I know a lot of people, I'm not getting down on people for doing roadmaps, but bro, if you've got a really good idea and you're just roadmapping it, kiss it goodbye, because it's out there. So that's why for me, I mean, that's just another reason why I don't like announcing what I'm going to do until I've done it and we can implement it. And it's like, then when I announce it, it's like, here's this thing. It's like, I didn't tell anybody about Starship until we had a Starship, right? So, right. Or a space station anyways. Right. So that's kind of the way you did it was, yeah, I feel you, man. I'm like I'm just biting my tongue, keeping stuff in, you know? It's
yeah. I mean, it's like waiting for Christmas, you know, because we've been dying to tell people about it. And like, you know, that's just the beginning of the utility that we're doing, right? So we're just, you know, we wanted to say, okay, we're about community, want to give back to the community. We want to build the community, and we want to show that we're doing things differently than any other project. We want to give you right away, and then build upon that. So we're building value upon value upon value, and that's what we're about. So it's kind of cool.
I tell you what, you and Jay, you guys happen to be the first ever partnership within a half an hour conversation I've ever had. So you guys are absolutely doing everything right. And I think you guys have a good system. And I think we're all in the greatest community that could be possible. Just the combination of communities, the fact that we're giving, we're all paying it forward. We know it takes a village. And I love you guys.
Thanks, Tim.
Love you too.
We just did an AMA with the Dragon Guild with TCG World this last Friday. So if anybody wants to just a couple cool details and get to see the Dragon Guild guys talk about something they love, it's on our YouTube channel TCG World. It's the latest video on there. So yeah, go check it out. They got a really cool thing.
If one of the mods can get to the TCG World and just drop that link in the chat, I would appreciate it. Thank you very much. Yeah, it's great because look at us. We're all quote-unquote competitors, right? But we're all trying to build each other up because that's what this whole space is like.
I think this is Web 3. Like, part of the Web 3 is the shift from, you know, it's that the space is big enough that we can support each other in the visions that we're creating and co-creating, and that together we're richer as a group of people. It's kind of like, you know, it's the Avengers. It's the Federation. Yeah. It's this thing where by each of our projects absolutely going so powerfully into the vision and the heart and the passion we represent, then together we collectively can just do even more incredible things.
To add on to that, like, so there's a leadership book that I read from time to time called The Best Damn Ship in the Navy. The Best Damn Ship in the Navy. It's a really cool story about this captain who takes over this like destroyer class battleship, and it had a terrible captain. The crew hated him. The crew was awful. And it's the whole story about how he was able to turn everything around. And it's just like the way he did it was incredible, like totally new for the military and everything. But at the very beginning of the book, he said, although this book is about my success with the battleship, if I would have go back in time and redo the whole thing, I would have worked with all the other captains and I would have done this as a fleet as opposed to me doing my own ship and making it great. I would have done it with a fleet mentality. And I honestly kind of think that's us. We're kind of this like fleet mentality, and we're all hooking up each other left and right, and we're all going to be more successful because of that, you know? And so, I love it.
I got to say, it's like a big interconnected web of all these different projects that are really close to each other right now. Each of them have their own little bit that goes to it. But like overall, in the space, there's a lot of Highlander mentality. You're a big project. Everybody else, they can just jump off a cliff. You just push them to the edge, and you know that's kind of those projects' goal. But I think a big thing that people don't realize is we're like 1% in the space right now. Mm-hmm. When it comes to NFTs, when it comes to metaverse, when it comes to crypto, you know, you look at Coinbase, you look at OpenSea, you look at the numbers and everything, and we're not there yet. There's so many more people coming in. And so if you're going to just like kind of Highlander yourself and just be on your own and push everybody else off, you're really hurting yourself, you know. I think connecting the different communities together, which is kind of my motto anyway, is a huge thing that's needed in this space. And I think, you know, bridging these different communities and people that are actually trying to, oh damn, that's a dragon.
nice.
People that are actually trying to like bridge these, you know, legitimate communities together. And there's just so many scams. There's so much this, there's so much that. And then there's the real people, you know, like us that are in here right now that are actually trying to build stuff. And we are building stuff. And the way that I can't say too much, but the way that, you know, our project and, you know, Dragon Guild, Starship, every project here tonight, pretty much, the way that we can connect our projects together and that we are, is a way to bring more people in the space. Because as Funky Monkey Frat House or Starship or Cyber Hornet, each of them have their great things. Like, you know, TCG World, it's a metaverse. Starship, it's a game. But the other ones, they all have their own niches. They have their own communities. They have their own people. If you can bring all that together and you can add utility on top of utility on top of utility on top of utility to where it's just like, why wouldn't you want to be in, right? Like, you got TCG, you got Starship, you got this, you got that, you got Madams and Monsters. Like, what in the hell else can you have? Like, you want a game? You got five. You want a metaverse? You got two. Like, what are you asking for at this point, you know? And you just bridge all those communities together. And if we're sitting here right now at 1%, what in the hell happens when we hit 50?
Yeah. Well, and I think that's so cool, because going off what Jordan, I think, was saying earlier, kind of like with Mike and pulling out of Marvel and all that and doing his own, like, I think that's going to be so cool for artists and creators across the world as crypto and NFTs and stuff become more and more adopted. You know, sometimes when a kid tells his parents, I'm going to go be an artist, like sometimes that can, they'll be supportive, you know, but now artists and people with creative minds, like, they're wanted so badly in the crypto space, and companies are starving just to find them because the pool is so low. And so here's a really cool space where people get to not only enjoy their passion, but they can make great income off it and really kind of be creative, which artists are creative, and this space allows that. So I think it's so cool. You don't have to work this 9-to-5 job that you hate. You get to be you and get paid for being you. And I think it's really cool.
As an artist, man, it's the creative juices. It's really funny. I relate this back to when I had my own comic book company. It was Alias Enterprises, and we had funding. We had $500,000 to create whatever we wanted. And it's something inside when you know that you're going to have an outlet, just unlocks the creative flow, man. And you're just, stuff is constantly coming to your mind of ideas of how you could do this, create stories, do this. And that's why it's like, man, with this now, I'm in a place right now where any crazy idea that I have an outlet to be like, hey, can we do this? And someone, one of you guys or someone else I'm working, they'll be like, yeah, let's do that. And it's like, I'm like, I'm going to take over the world. there's so much. As a creator, that's just, boy, when you're just working a job where you're like, I have to do this much work, this, you know, every week, just to try to pay my mortgage and all that stuff. boy, you just get dammed up. The creative juices just stop up like you're constipated. And I'm in this space right now is just so exciting for me. It's crazy.
Well, and that's, I think another difference is the level of empowerment that is happening in the space within each other and the projects that we're working on, that it's not like this traditional model where someone on top with all of the money is going and hiring all of you to work on, like all of us to work on things we don't want to be a part of, or we want to be a part of, but we're not seeing a part of return on that or a return on investment in time and energy. And really we're all from the top down saying, let's build everyone up together. Let's build all this up together. You know, people who are in the community, who are moderators for other things, they're also holding the NFTs in the project. They believe in the project. They're participating in something that they believe and want to see come to fruition. And that's why I think the era of the NFT projects versus projects with NFTs. NFT project, you know, let's throw a visual up. Let's try to get speculative and get hype. And some people will win if they have like the one rare one and everyone else loses. And now they're going to look for something else. Is different than what we're all, I think, doing, which is saying we want to build something with vision and purpose, and people can come and participate with that, and we'll build these things together in like a legacy way, in a mindset that's going to make things of significance and things of art and things of purpose, and the NFT just empowers and enables that because it's a mechanism of digital scarcity, but it's attached to the visions that we're talking about, that people can say, I resonate with that. I want to be a part of that. I want to bring that into being. And so, you know, that's
well, the one. And going back to part of what you were saying, it's there is still the superstructure of like, you know, guys creating projects and hiring artists. Mm-hmm. But that's the great part is that there is so much reward in this space that I can turn around and I can negotiate a price. Like I negotiated with Robert to have Matt work on his thing. But I got a price that allows Matt the freedom to do this and then have enough, enough month at the end of his bills, whatever, or bills. How do you say it?
Bills. At,
yeah, whatever. Whichever. He's making enough money where after he does this project, he could sit there and focus on his own stuff without, yeah. You know, without the, yeah. The mm-hmm. pay your rent. And you know, it's like rent's time. Taken care of. It's, you know,
yeah.
It's.
Yeah.
That I mean, kind of freedom, the creative juices, that's mm-hmm. Matt's going to be like killing it. Preston?
Yeah. And at the same time, they're able to step away from what they might have been doing because they are getting paid more in the NFT art space than they would have gotten paid yep. in comic mm-hmm. book space.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's really
it benefits the everybody. Really?
Yeah, exactly.
If you look at some
sort of a work for hire system that I've built with, you know, Preston and Robert and some of these other guys, it's advantaging, like Preston's saying, it's advantaging both parties. But it's also a stepping stone for those guys to end up doing their own stuff and their own NFT projects, because that's the thing. It's like you come in and now you like you're the artist on the Animus project. Now you've got a fan base inside the colony, and you know that's how I got a bunch of guys from Pluto Alliance. It's like I was the Pluto Alliance artist, and so I could go in there, and I know I've got a 30-year record in comics, which gives me whatever reputation, but I didn't bring any of those fans over from comics. The thousands, tens of thousands, I don't even know how many fans I have in the comic world, none of those guys are in crypto, but the guys in these communities are. And right. That's, you know, this is, becomes a stepping stone. And then hopefully this just all pays forward and just builds up everybody. And we can just, because we're not even pioneers. I always say we're not pioneers. We're not even off the Mayflower yet. You know, this is going to be so much bigger than any of us can imagine.
Right. And what's nice is like when we got negotiated with you on Matt, and then you know Jay and I were like, well, what are we going to do after for Matt so that we can like him get continue to be paid and stuff like that. So we're going to do charity events and stuff, and like a third of the charity proceeds will go to him, third will nice. Go to the charity, and a third will go to the community. So you That's know right. so when we build it, as we build going forward, you know, it's just like, you know, Matt wants to make a little extra money. Let's do another charity event, right?
Yeah. Sure you want to do that, Matt?
It's good. Yeah, that sounds good to me.
Good for the world. So I mean, what? I mean, win, win, win. What else could be better, right?
You get to make a happy artist and makes put happy art.
Yeah.
Hopefully, it makes the world happy.
Happy little clouds.
Yeah, and then just looking at the chat here, it's like, yeah, and that's the fantastic thing. It's not just us. It's us on the screen, the business guys, the art guys, whatever. Man, the community benefits from this. Everybody buying every NFT, every plot of land, they're all benefiting from this as long as we continue to benefit them. And it all works symbiotically.
Right.
It's not a one-sided thing.
It'll lift all ships.
Yeah,
rising tides, yeah. Well, yeah. And I think just to add on to that too, like I think a lot of people originally get into crypto to get a Lambo, right? They think I'm going to get rich, so I'm going to get into crypto, I'm going to do this thing. This is where I'm going to make it big. So a lot of people come into crypto with that mentality. But as people kind of start to hang out and learn about these like NFT communities and learn about these movements and these visions that these projects have, all of a sudden, like their paradigm shifts to where like, man, I'm about this for a whole nother reason now. I'm about crypto for a whole nother reason. I love these guys. I love their mission. I love what they're doing. I want to support them. And a lot of that kind of me starts to fade away as it becomes more of like an us type situation. And it's really cool.
That's the WGMI, right?
Well, and I think part of bridging that all together, I guess, is like expectations. Like I think a lot of people see things that have went like 10,000x in like a day, and they think that's like realistic. I think joining communities that can 100x in a year, that's much better. When I personally myself, I stepped in from the stock market, COVID hit, I moved into crypto, I moved into NFTs. And I was like, but you know, I pulled something with GameStop. I pulled something with AMC, you know, Wall Street Bets. I was over in those communities. I don't think, what's his name, who added me today, the head of Wall Street Bets. I forget his name.
Chris?
Yeah. I don't think he knows who I am, but I was in the forums. I was talking with GME and AMC. I was playing some option calls, you know. One of them I could have turned, what was it? $1,200 into about $1 million, but I ended up pulling out early. Didn't make nearly that much.
That's what she said.
But I looked at crypto and I was like, risk to reward. You do your research. You move in here. You look at metaverses. You really do some research. You look at some coins. You really do your research. You look at some NFTs. You really do your research. You know, it might be 5 months. It might be a year. It might be nothing, but your overall risk to reward is so much. I mean, what do you expect in the stock market? I mean, you play a good, play some Tesla, you get 50% in a year. You play some, you know, S&P, you get 7%. Mm-hmm. You play some crypto and NFTs and some metaverse, and you actually do some due diligence. You actually get in there and learn. You talk to the people like Alex, you talk to the people like Mike, you know, all these people, you really get in there and you learn and see what they're building. And, you know, 10X, 20X, I don't even think that's not even really a starting point in crypto, is it? In a year?
I mean, I'm loving all this conversation, but we should give something away. Because
do it.
I was like, we're all just hanging out. I'm like, yeah, we're just,
you know, it's a frat party. We're
all talking, absolutely. But sorry to interrupt. I think we'll come back to this conversation later. Mike has rare NFTs that he's done a fractionalized version of a rare NFT. There's only 10. They're only being given away at this event. One was won earlier in the giveaway in the Discord. And we are giving away the other 9 through the lottery draws. Mike is currently finding that image.
scrolling.
While he is finding that image, we are next going to give away the two. We're going to do the two Genesis lottery draws, and we are going to do a third one as well. Okay, Mike, talk about that image.
All right, so I actually did this a while ago, but with the resurgence of Sir Elon of Musk, and you know that means he's going to be pumping Doge again. I thought this would be an ideal time to launch the incredible Doge NFT. And I added in the background, if you can see here, we got a Funky Monkey, we got a Crypto Chad, we got an Animus.
And hey, that Animus looks like the one from TCG.
That's right.
Babel Fett?
That's right. The TCG Animus.
Oh, no, that's a...
And the Meta Bounty Hunter email form, which is may or may not be coming out sometime soon.
But I thought it was like Babe Fett or something.
Babe
Fett. I like that.
Yeah, so I was never a huge fan of Doge, but I understand its importance in the space, and frankly, I really do think if Elon does continue to add value to it's so funny because it's not even his token, but he's the one adding value to it. But so the Incredible Doge based off of the Incredible Hulk cover, obviously.
I was gonna say that looks kind of Incredible Hulkish, coincidentally.
Yeah. No, it's not a coincidence at all.
Is he meme or monster?
Or is he both?
dun dun dun.
So that is a good segue into we're gonna be giving...
that's a Halloween edition there too. I just noticed.
October 31st.
Mm-hmm.
And it's one ETH. And it's approved by the Crypto Code Authority.
I love how you put in the little details that you sneak in there for people who actually pay attention and look deeply.
Tell me what the SN is.
The which?
SN is between the stamp and like the 31st of October.
Yeah, you know what? I don't know. I don't remember what that was for. It was on the original cover. So
it's cryptic.
Yeah. So you can make something up for it. It'll be fine.
So while Mike is finding a random number generator.
It is Saturday night.
Is it? It is.
Yeah.
Saturday night.
SN.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Saturday night.
So Mike is going to find a random number generator.
I thought you found one.
No, you didn't like the ones I find. You like some when they're like fancier.
I have one built into my server. I can just punch a number into you.
What's up?
I said, I love it because you guys are talking and I'm getting drunk. Let's give something away.
Hey, it's a win.
What are you giving away? So, get more drunk. Give me something.
So well, Preston, you're actually...
Wallet. I'll drop a planet.
Okay, well, you can handle that in the YouTube channel. So, Mike, you're going to go through numbers 1 to 267. This is going to be for Genesis Custom. But what are we giving away? So we are giving away a Toga Monkey first, but then we're giving away... a Animus and a Cyber Hornet. And so I thought Preston could quickly, maybe we'll give away the Toga and Preston can think about what he wants to say, but he can just say why Cyber Hornets and Animuses are cool and what's coming out for them shortly that I may know about. 1 to 267. So let's give it a test run.
All right. This doesn't count. So I apologize to whoever it lands on. I'm sorry for getting your hopes up.
If the numbers are going. Stop.
I was going to say, I bet it's going to be 88.
You're
close. I was going to say that.
So the next run will be for the Genesis Custom winner who will get a Toga Monkey, Toga Frat Monkey.
All right. Toga Monkey for a Genesis coming up. I'm going to do 3 seconds. One 1,000. 2 1,000, 3 1,000.
Hold your breath.
Oh.
Whoa.
2 43.
Okay. Jordan. So now, well, you can look
two,
it up.
4 3.
So now open it up on your screen and search it.
Oh.
Is that way you can screen share? And that way we're all.
2.c.wham. Check your wallet.
And now the tension. Oh, and we also get to see a cool Genesis Custom. Who's it by? Oh.
Ooh,
it's
Ice.
Dave Chimpel.
Dave Chimpel.
So Dave, the holder of Dave Chimpel is going to be getting a Toga Monkey sent to them.
No joke. I'm so pissed. The last week I was leaving Oregon, right? I was working at Banner Dunes Golf Resort, right? Puffin. I got it on right now. I went to go play golf, and I was like, let me book out this tee time, right? Got it. Got everything ready. Went to the golf resort, Banner Dunes Golf Resort, one of the biggest in the U.S. They told me I couldn't play because Dave Chappelle had booked three fucking tee times that day. And I was like, are you kidding me? And they're like, yeah, he brought in a group of 24. I'm sorry, you can't play golf. And I'm like... Anyway, so Dave Chappelle. That's my story.
He screwed me. We love Dave Chappelle.
Yeah. That congratulations, 2-4-3, you jerk.
You ruined my last tee time in Oak again before I moved.
not you, your Genesis custom, okay? You jerk.
Yeah, okay. But he made 23 other people happy that day.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Buzz, tell us about the Animus, because we're giving away an Animus next. Oh, there's a deer on my front lawn.
All right. So the Animus, dear. That one, he's geared up for war. He's got some really cool traits. I can't say Star Wars mask, but it is kind of Star Wars mask. the Animus is going to be used in the upcoming PDE game. Animus will also be able to get access to redeem one of the digital comics. You'll have 2 weeks to be able to redeem your NFT that gives you access to the digital Cyber Hornet comic number one.
That's good.
The art was done by Elliot Fernandez.
Who is the Funky Monkey art monkey?
That's right.
That is awesome. Yeah.
You can see Elliot and me and Matt, everybody, every Wednesday night at 7 o'clock Pacific Standard Time, doing some sort of a drawing and hanging out show. So
drawing and quartering, right?
It was drawn and quartered, but I haven't really. That takes a lot more organization. So lately, we've just been doing think and draw.
Oh, gotcha.
We're all too busy working on NFTs.
I think the last thing and draw, I may have convinced you to drop a sneak peek of the TCG Animus.
Oh, that's fine.
Alex is here. I don't know if he's seen him.
I haven't seen it yet.
Well, later on, Mike was going to be sharing
Mike,
that, but if
how long is share... Alex here?
I'll be here for a little bit.
Okay.
I mean, it's convenient.
If you want to share Animus. The TCG Animus now.
Yeah, I was just going to pop in for 5 minutes and it's turned into an hour.
It's too good. I don't even know how long I've been here. Almost two.
A TCG sneak peek.
There's Animus. I just saw he went away.
We're also going to be giving away a TCG silver plot at some point is a live giveaway, Alex. And we're giving away one to a lottery winner as well. So we're giving away two silver plots tonight.
Here, I do this the wrong way. I just like skip through stuff I'm probably not supposed to show. But Alex, I never signed an NDA, so sorry.
Yeah, that's okay.
Dave's sleeping. Whatever you want. Dave's sleeping. It's all good, right?
You have an electric collar with Jordan, but with us, you're a free man. You do whatever you want.
Where's my button?
Yeah.
Okay.
These are some of the creatures, but we're trying to get back to the Animus. Hold on a second.
I may or may not talk to David about these guys that Mike then made.
They look so good.
They look fun.
In TCG world...
I just
got
to say, he stoned a little bit. Like, it's 420. His eye gets a little small.
Hey, he's tired, man. He just woke up from hibernation.
The baby is... The baby's bright-eyed.
The baby's on crack.
Caffeine.
Yeah. The baby's on crack, and they.
So yeah, these Animus will make their way into TCG World once they get modeled. I'm looking forward to it.
Their irises change color. Is that scientifically accurate?
Of course.
Oh, okay,
they're not necessarily the same one though. It's not necessarily the same one in different stages, or does it have to be?
I think it is, but he does have the white version too. Do you have the white version, Andy?
The white album?
The northern region.
The northern.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Animus of the North.
Oh, the baby.
I really like the baby.
Green.
He's so cute.
Then it's the TCG ring colors.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Let's do it. I'm down.
And so, Alex, these are going to be creatures who that are catchable, right, in the TCG game? Is that one of the functions in TCG?
Yep. Yeah, we're going to have a lot of creature stuff within our world. But yes, that is one of them.
Yeah, because I mean, think not everyone here is necessarily familiar with TCG. So one of the parts of the metaverse is a creature capture component, right?
And all custom made by Mike. So we're not going to use stuff online. Like, we want to make our own awesome creatures. We want to model, animate, and do all the cool stuff that we're doing with them to really provide a special experience to everybody. And then here's kind of what they look like.
Just to ask you a question, Alex, because I think I missed a tiny bit. So there's the three different colors of rings, right? And I watched like one of Jace's videos, and he was like catching some stuff. Is that like the different kinds of balls? Like one ring has less of a chance to capture that creature. One ring has more of a chance. One ring has more of a chance. This is kind of like the Pokeballs, how they have different colors.
You can't talk about that.
I was going to say, actually, that's a Mike question.
Alpha. Mike, you're not even talking. Alex, you just said you had no NDA. What are you doing?
So we're going to be giving away a Genesis custom next.
Alex, you came up with a freaking great idea. I think we should do that with all the creatures.
Yeah.
The different eye colors for each stage. Yeah.
Yeah.
And have progressive balls that catch better.
Progressive rings.
Rings to capture with, yes. So next we are doing one more Genesis custom draw, and this one is for the Animus, as well as the rare NFT that Mike has drawn. And also, every lottery winner is getting a Dragon Guild whitelist plus OG pass. So
is this to 267 again? Aren't we doing that?
Yes, you are doing this. And yes, it's 267 again. It's one more Genesis custom. And then after this, we're doing Genesis custom and Frat Monkeys to come win.
All right, Zach, how many seconds should
if it's from 1 to 267, that means the numbers 1 and 267 can't win, right?
No, they can't they?
You would want to do it from 0 then, wouldn't you?
I think number 1 can be picked. Because anything from number 1, which is 1, to 267, which is 267.
Primitive. Well, I guess it depends on how your NFT can arrive. List.
Well, let's just do it 267 times, and then we'll know if it pops up statistically.
Only if it canceled the thing.
Let's go.
It would take more than that.
3.1.
You gotta drink every time too. Alex.
You have to wait 3.14 seconds.
Alex, take 267 shots.
I'm gonna press start here, and then you just tell me when to press stop.
Now.
No fun at all.
That was a good. Someone needs Octopi. Can you capture Zach's saying now and make that something that we can use
instead? Now.
Now.
It would be Squidward.
No. At some point here. Okay, so which is number 182? At some point, I want an AA, Ron.
Oh yeah.
And what about a Zach?
AA, Ron. Well, it makes more sense when Aaron's here. This is the one everybody appreciates.
Crypto is a lousy investment.
Wait, hold on. I gotta ask, how many people seen the SNL of crypto?
Oh, the Elon one?
The NFT song?
NFT, yeah.
Yeah, I seen that one.
It's too good.
Okay, the winner of the Animus from Cyber Hornets, which will later be able to be used in the staking play-to-earn game that they're creating, which is very cool. And also be associated with the digital comic.
AGN.
Ooh. Nice. Oh, and it's a Funky AGN. Monkey Space Force custom, Genesis custom, which were with Starship's launch.
Okay, so question, the gun, is that like plasma? What is it?
Set phasers on
fire. It's a phase plasma rifle in the 40
watt
range.
Rick and Morty portal gun. What do you mean?
It kind of looks like a Rick and Morty portal gun. like a futuristic version.
Maybe it also has a bubble setting. You know, makes a little
kind of reminds me of the Star Trek phaser too.
Okay, so congratulations, AAGN. You have won a Animus. And now, you know what? We're here, so let's do it now. A Cyber Hornet. We're giving away the Cyber Hornet. This is going
to send me this.
Hold on a second.
I will. Octopi
is
collecting
the information. Saying when I'm saying phase plasma rifle in the 40 watt range.
I do.
And I'm going to say
Terminator.
Terminator. That's right. All right.
Oh man, I just went through all those movies like a month ago. I didn't catch it.
The next random draw is going to be between 1 and 2,267. If it's a number between 1 and 2,000, that will be a funky monkey, frat monkey, a toga, or a Greek. 2,267, because there's 267 customs.
All right.
So do a test there. Just
Alex, tell me when to stop.
Okay. Let's go right about maybe this moment now.
Ooh. Okay, so
800 again.
802 is going to be a toga.
A toga. Oh.
Mm. Toga. Toga.
Toga. Toga. Where the toga? The wrong one.
By the way, Alex, you sound way better than you did earlier.
Thank you. Yeah, I got to stop doing stuff like this because I got to.
I'm
really going to
send you
heal,
some honey and some of this like 802? Pollen.
802.
I've got a buddy in Oregon that does like bee pollen and honey, and I can just like get it shipped to you.
And it's number 802.
Yeah, I'm down.
Number 802.
Are you in the Klamath Valley or where?
Epic NFTs.
Central Oregon.
Epic NFTs. Wentz. What kind of characteristics does that guy have? There's some. I like the tie.
He's got the haircut looks fabric nice. Of time behind him. Yeah. Here's
and what is
he's got the picnic blanket sheet. His eyes are focused. His head Ooh. Color is dark. His hand is where the hair holding going. The ETH word 40. Facial hair is granddaddy chin or chimp. Red gelled up hair, grinning, and the yellow mellow spotted tie. Not a bad one. And what is he winning?
Winning the which one's it? This was this is the Cyber Hornet, the ape Cyber Hornet.
Oh, very nice.
Right? Congratulations.
Yeah. Congratulations.
Congrats.
Preston, you'll want to talk to Jordan about that.
Right now, Octopi is collecting all the information with the addresses and then I'll provide it to
if
all
I
the
get
people.
Address, although I can send.
That yellow liquid looks a little sus.
You got to go. You got to go. What was the Dumb and Dumber? Dumb and Dumber.
What is that? Is that an old English that's been filled back up? Is that what that is?
So doing a little bit.
I will punch you in the face.
Did you got that just for me? Didn't you?
Right? Yeah, I wanted to use it on you earlier, but that's fine.
Right. It's okay. You'll find use for
I've
it again.
I've been summoned. I'll be right back.
Okay. So next on the itinerary was
fat, drunk, and stupid is no way to go through life, son. <That's
random. laughs> Thank you.
Wow.
That's okay. Next on the itinerary is actually the Funky Monkey Space Force Starship Enterprise. Starship Update. Sorry, I had a moment. Grandpa's running me messages.
Is Grandpa doing that one?
No, he just wrote me a message and I got distracted by it.
Oh. Well, bro, you know me. That's I don't have time to play that game. So I don't have time for anything.
That's true. Okay.
That's why Chucky is in charge.
Yes, but he's moving right now. So so basically a very quick update for people
right,
who
Jordan is giving the update then for there we
yes.
go.
That's hello. Oh wow, that's bright and me in the face. So basically this is too serious. I can't handle it.
So it looks good on you though.
Thank you. So basically we just wanted to give a quick update to the people that are part of the frat that are playing in Funky Monkey Space Force, because we have the Kyanite share that goes to different holders of different ratios. And Starship is going to be launching a feature soon, and I'm allowed to say two things, that stations will be staking Kyanite to unlock features going into the future. One of those is going to be ship rental abilities, and the other one in phase 3 is going to be faster than light, or FTL. It was just written FTL, so I'm going to assume that maybe that's a problem. So in light of this, we our station isn't collecting a huge amount right now, but they just launched the three extra ships. So now we have six ships. And so we're going to be taking the kyanite and we're going to be keeping that in the station for now as the features get rolled out, because once, because it's very value adding to be getting these features. And since we're looking at this as a long-term game and play, that's what has been decided amongst the Funky Monkey Space Force High Council. We can, of course, discuss this in the Funky Monkey Space Force chat channel. How's that sound, Mike?
Oh, that sounds good.
You know what? I think it was like, yeah, you know what it is? It's like, let's put the camera on Jordan while I go to the bathroom.
Yep, pretty much. Yeah.
That's what it is. Some iced tea.
Yeah.
Iced tea, making some more. It's okay. You know what? Everyone has. Everybody has to make ETH ale sometimes.
Cheers to that.
See, I'm so slow at this. I should have punched you in the
I got it. So wait, one second. Grandpa, did everything I say, was it okay? Was it kosher?
Absolutely. For the staking for phase three that you mentioned for the FTL, I think we've settled on hyperspace engine, and the stations will all have like a hyper gate that allows travel to other planets, making it easier to complete quests and things like that. You know, get you faster travel when new space stations open, if you want to go purchase planets or things like that.
Excellent. So,
and did you want to talk about like the virtual stuff that you're doing, or any other updates?
There was a leak, a little tease leak with a virtual interior, but
yeah, it's just some basically some optional add-ons that the developers are wanting to put in, just kind of like per station. It's not a major part of the NFT game. We want to keep it accessible to everybody, and we know everybody's not doesn't have access to VR necessarily, but just something to keep it interesting and something we can expand on in the future.
Cool. Yeah. So I just, when I say I don't have time to play it, that's not, I hope that didn't come off wrong. I have no time.
No,
it's okay. I try to
keep my ships running, and it's hard sometimes just with everything that's going on, you know.
And that's your job.
Yeah. I mean, it's one of them.
So Grandpa, with these 10 extended packs that you sent me, where are we? Are those going out as the live giveaways, or do we want to give those to the lottery winners? I still have other packs I'm sending out.
It's completely up to you. I mean, they're yours to do it as you see fit. If you want to add them into the 10 winners of the fractional, that's fine. If you want to give them to 10 other people, however you want to do it.
In that case, I think we're going to give them away as live giveaways, because we're going to give them to people that have wax wallets. Otherwise, it's going to go to people who won't have wax wallets, who then might not want to do all that.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. All right. Well, thank you. Thank you very much. Is there anything else you'd like to talk about Starship-wise?
As long as you have the screen.
Yeah, you're here. We're here.
Anybody that doesn't know, we just started phase two officially with the launch of the second fleet, three extra ships. They're going to be the same rarity as your first set of ships. So which means that the added value of owning more Starship token, you basically get double the benefit from that now. So something to consider when you're deciding whether to upgrade your NFTs or, you know, get more tokens. Next thing up is going to be the quest line for phase two, which will eventually enable the hyperspace travel. So look forward to that. And then we're also working on the ship rentals, where, you know, we can get guilds or people that don't have time to play the game, but want to invest in the project. You can basically it's kind of like an Axie Scholar feature where you invest, you own the NFTs, but you enable somebody else to use them. Is what awesome. We're calling ship rentals.
Nice.
Awesome.
And I'm just going to let people know that if you want to win some of the wax packs that have just been dropped, I'm going to be looking for addresses, wax wall addresses, in our Funky Monkey Space Force channel in our Discord. So,
yeah. So the people dropping your wax addresses in this chat, you please go to the description. Actually, people, you can drop here. Let me drop it. HTTP. Discord.gg/FunkyMonkeyFathouse. Go to the Discord, and that's where you drop that.
And go to the Funky Monkey Space Force channel. That's where I'm going to be looking. Because that way we have the wax wallets going there, where also the people can help and whatnot.
Yeah, and here's the Funky Monkey Space Force as we're talking about them. So.
What's the deal with those monkeys, Mike?
These monkeys get 25% between the 200 monkeys that are here, get 25% of the kyanite generated by our space station. They were just like with the launch chads, how we had a progenitor set to the full set. We did this in order to fund getting the space station and some other stuff. So yeah. These are a great, small, tight collection of 200 space monkeys. And like I said, between just these 200 at a floor price of 0.38, you get 25% split between these 200 for the kyanite.
That's cool.
That's huge.
Yeah. I think...
And there's some cool ones I like.
These. Yeah, 25% split between the 200.
Yeah, that's nothing to shy away from.
So, you know, you might want to pick up a couple there.
Here, I'll put the link in the chat.
The floor is actually really low on that, pretty low on them right now.
Yeah, 0.38.
I think what happened is with the delay in our station.
Oh, here's a funny story.
People exited their monkeys to get other stuff, and now the station's launched and things are rolling, but people haven't necessarily come back yet.
So this particular monkey, I believe it's this one, was stolen from my son's account. And then, okay, so my son, I have four NFT worlds, right? And I got them because my kids play Minecraft. So I'm like, oh, they can build these NFT worlds, build cool stuff on them, and then we'll sell them for, at the time, you know, stuff that had stuff built on them, you could sell for higher than the floor price. And so I was going to have them build stuff, sell it, and then, you know, make a profit off that and go buy another floor model. So it was on my son's computer. That computer got phished, malwared. They wiped his MetaMask wallet out with my NFT world and all of them. He had a couple of monkeys on there and all of his crypto. So this one, and you know, there's nothing you can do. And I'm not going to punish whoever bought it from the guy that stole it, because he did sell it like right away. But yeah. Looks like he's back on the market. So anyways, be careful with your crypto, ladies and gentlemen, because stuff like this does happen.
Yes, it's a good cautionary tale for all of us. And please, if you don't know what you're doing, ask in all of our Discords, because we all have people who will help you be more safe with not doing janky stuff.
Yeah.
So let's move on to the next giveaway. Let's do it. Let's do it. Do it now. Get to the chopper. Okay. So next, we are giving away a Meta Bounty Hunter. We're giving away TCG Silver Plot. So I'm glad that Alex is still here, because he can help pick that one.
Yeah.
But first, we're going to do the Meta Bounty Hunter. Mike, do you want to represent?
Yeah, hold on. I'm going to bring this up because I just want to point out to people, I was, you know, I work for those guys. And so, you know, these things aren't, that's 1.4 ETH floor price right now. So I wasn't like, when I asked them if they had, you know, wanted to give one away, I wasn't really expecting them to say yes, but they did. So this is a big get, because you also get reflections, which is, if you own one of these, you get free Ethereum every week. you know, it's not like a ton, but it's free money.
Did so, you do the art for them?
If you win this, you just won a lifetime of free Ethereum.
Wow.
Nice. So, and yeah, and so this is the thing, going to talk about like NFTs and projects that have utility and do reflections or random airdrops, RADs, things like that. Meta Bounty Hunters definitely checks those boxes.
Yep.
So that's exciting, because like the floor on this right now, when I checked earlier, it was like 1.059 ETH, which now we're at 1.04.
All right. So what am I, what's the numbers I'm doing?
You're going to, same numbers. So all the okay. other ones are these same numbers. So.
All right. Let me pick someone else. Preston, tell me when to stop.
Did he come back?
It's the long pause. He's just over there nodding.
Stop. Right. Okay, I didn't realize I was still muted. Damn it.
I know. I saw you saying something that whole time.
He's like,
did you hear the heart for these mics?
I did.
Sorry to the other three winners.
It looks like you're right.
This is a Genesis custom.
2144.
Genesis custom 144.
All right, Genesis custom.
I haven't used this software before, so I keep muting via my mic because it has.
Where's my Genesis button? Did I close it?
So this is for the winner of the Meta Bounty Hunter. And so everyone who's watching this, you know, we're giving away 15,000 in prizes this party. This is a quarterly frat party. We do this four times a year. And then there's the annual one is the fourth one. And we also have giveaways in our Discord for regular frat monkeys. Ooh.
Oh, yeah. Jungle J. Very nice.
All right. Nice. Congratulations, Jungle J.
Jungle J. Created by you.
Well, I mean, it's a custom, so I drew it.
It's a Mike Miller custom.
And look at that Cardano Club.
And so next, we are doing a TCG Silver plot.
Nice. And that is same numbers?
Now, yeah, same numbers. Now, Alex, these are currently one, are they currently one BNB to buy, but then at 90%, they bump up to a higher price?
Yeah, they
price.
Get a full retail, like four or seven, right? I think four.
Like four?
Here, what we'll do is...
this is Alex. This is your call.
Oh, he's...
Oh, okay, hold on. I'm thinking of a different way.
He's going to do a different way.
Let's do... Oh, okay. We'll do... is Starship... Anybody on from Starship?
In here, in our thing, or in the chat?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. There's. I think. Okay. Is Grandpa still here?
Yep, I'm still here.
Okay, yep. Grandpa, pick a number between 1 and 4.
3.
Okay, Dragon Guild, Robert, pick a number between 1 and 4.
7.
That's not one between 1 and 4.
An outside of the box thinker.
2. Okay, because. So we're going to add those together. So we're going to 3 and 4, 3 and 2. So we're going to run it 5 times. And the reason was because we just did an AMA with the Dragon Guild, and we just did a Twitter space with Starship this last week. So we're going to run it 5 times.
That breaks
stop,
4 people's
start,
heart.
Stop, start, stop, start.
All right, that's one.
One.
Sorry, 1914. That's two. Sorry, 2079.
No.
I love your drum roll sound. I'm a big fan of your drum roll sound.
4. All right, here we go.
Here we go. Alex, you say when to stop. Tell me when to stop, Alex.
Just go for it. Yeah, whatever.
No, you tell me. Do it.
No, just go. Just go.
Okay, so this is gonna be a Greek. This is gonna be a Greek one.
Great number. In fact, that number is all odd numbers, which makes it amazing.
Yeah.
Because we're all odd on this call.
Yeah, right. Well, I mean, not for nothing. It does have a 7 in there, right? A couple times.
Yeah, 2 7s.
Yeah.
Extra lucky.
797, Mr. Tuxedo and Sipsic. Congratulations, Sipsic. You've got rectangled background. I like the background.
Yeah, I do too.
Blue fancy tux, weepy eyes, can't chop. I don't know. Can't chop, won't stop, I think. What do you have? Hand, pure beer, blue ribbon. Beige hair, royal visor, PBR, that's right. Grinning and no neckwear. So except he's got a tie, but I don't want to explain
doesn't
it.
Count.
Yeah.
So congratulations, Sipsick.
Congratulations, man.
All right. Next on the itinerary was Mike Show's TCG creatures, but you know what?
We already did that.
Next is a giveaway for ETH Towers, Ethereum Towers.
You don't have any like secret TCG creatures you haven't shown yet?
I mean, I've got more on my. You know, I mean, I just go through all of them.
Yes, frat party.
Okay, you do that.
Any of the ones yet? Mike, have you shown any of the animated ones?
Platypus.
There's some modeled ones in here, I think.
I saw a couple the other night.
Is that a rat bat?
It's a ferret.
That's right. It's rat bat.
Yeah, it's rat bat.
Bunny
it's
rat bat.
It's rat bat. Rabbit.
Okay, and just so everyone knows, I'm gonna give away
and then ferret.
Ferret.
Which, by the way, everybody on this call, we are looking for names for these creatures. We have some ideas, but we love hearing community ideas. So if you see one of these creatures that we post in chat or just over on our group chats or something, and you think of a cool name, let us let Mike know. Say, "Oh, I came up with a cool name of that one thing." It has the legs and the eyes. That thing. Try to explain it to him.
And if you're dropping wallet addresses, go drop them in the Funky Monkey Space Force in our Discord. That's where I am just sending out packs.
Yeah, Discord link is in the description. So yeah, this
JC3 little rat bat, rabbat, and fair rat.
Yeah,
those are great names.
There you go. Fair bat. Yeah, fair rat. Yeah.
He said fair rat.
Which I know. I don't
like it. Work. And rabat.
So this little round dude over here that looks kind of like a Pokemon, I actually created that like in 1990. So that's a Gribbage. And it's the disembodied head of a Cabbage Patch doll that's been possessed. And it like eats everything in sight. So it's like a little walking Pac-Man. But it's I actually made an animation of this when I was in college.
That would be like a good D&D character.
I actually made a doll that ate things, and the motor wouldn't stop until it was done eating it. They actually pulled it from the shelves. It ate kids' hair and fingers. That's a real thing.
Valuable lessons were learned that day.
Life imitates art.
So is and that TCG safe for that to be in one. Is that TCG safe? It eats everything in the metaverse. I mean, is that safe to let that thing out?
Sure.
Don't eat it after midnight.
What's the thing that starts with an L that was like a Stephen King?
Lorax.
Langoliers.
Yes. Langoliers.
Hey, Mike, do a Stephen King-inspired Lorax. That's some Cyclones level stuff.
I actually like this guy. I don't know what the heck you're going to do with him, but...
I love the dad bod.
Yeah. Right? Dad bod. I mean, it's basically, you know, like Jabba the Hutt's cousin or something, but whatever.
Right. I like to think that things will live on the internet for like long after us, and years from now, someone will be streaming this. They'll just work to it streaming on repeat in the background. Remember that? The frat party number 2? Yeah, that was a classic.
I recognize
it. There's a cool story about this one, Mike.
What?
About this one right here. There's something cool, right?
Oh, well, I mean, that's Alex. What was it? I created the first little character, which just was like, you know, a snail with legs, and then Nick was like, he's the one that made up the other two. He's like, oh yeah, you should do one where the shell becomes a backpack and he's bigger and then it becomes a helmet. And so I'm like yeah, that's cool. So
but the shell's the same size, right?
Yeah,
all three
yeah.
of them. So yeah, it's like one of those illusions. It looks different, but they're actually the same size.
Yeah, it's the same shell.
Never grew.
Add some more legs to the small one and call him Cinta Snail. I don't know. Man.
I'm done drawing it.
He's done. He's gotta move on.
I'm supposed to be doing thousands of these things, so
must have on a wall just before that.
Somewhat? Oh, yeah. Goats. Well, that's why I was like trying to do like their little hooves, like tiny.
I went to Colorado, and that was like the cliffside of one of the mountains we were going by. And was like this SUV. It was a black Escalade, and it was some Asian tourists, and they pulled up, right? And they stopped, and they got out to go take pictures of these goats on the mountain, right, in Colorado. And they're all looking at them and taking pictures. And next thing you know, and there were signs that were just like, do not stop for goats, unless they're in the road. And these guys stop in the black, beautiful Escalade. And next thing you know, they're out taking pictures. Nobody's in the car. And these boulders just start coming down the hill.
No.
And just taco, flip this Escalade like two times. The boulders coming down the hill. And we were in like a Tahoe. And my buddy, he saw the boulders coming. And he was already backing up like because there was nobody behind us. And he's like, yeah, let's get back. And yeah,
that's it was crazy. A funny story.
Crushed it.
So yeah, I do. I do a lot of.
That's my favorite spider, by the way.
Back at that thing, yeah.
It's yeah, great. That thing lives life to the fullest.
It's like Cinco de Mayo and a spider.
Yeah,
he's ready for carnival. Yeah,
yeah.
Jamming spider.
Australian freaking weird moth. I don't know what the hell that thing is. It's so bizarre.
Oh my gosh, that thing exists.
I know. I didn't draw that, Alex. That's real.
Really,
dude? If that lived in my house, I would move.
Let's turn that into TCG.
If that lived in my country, I would move.
That's what I'm saying. Why is all that stuff in Australia? It's so funny.
Okay. I hate to ruin the fun, but next we're doing the ETH Towers because we gotta move on here.
There's so many.
Oh,
that's a cute one.
There you go. Yeah, that one's cool.
Right?
Yeah. I like him.
Oh, yeah, that does look cool.
Do you do the 3D modeling too?
No, I don't do this.
You have to pay Mike more to model.
Can I strap on with my avatar like that thing on the back and fly around? Like
I got it, Jordan. Cool.
Thank you.
That would be sweet.
there's the helper.
Oh, these are cool.
Porch is cool. Can't get a word out.
Rahul, do I just keep posting my address? Because that's what it looks like everybody else is doing.
Yeah, you know, well, I'm going through there. I'm sending out stuff just nonstop here. But I'm also trying not to send things to the same person twice. So if you've seen your address posted in what I'm dropping there, or you check your wallet and you see you've received things, you probably don't have to keep posting.
Hey, Mike, real quick, go back to the Centaur thing. Go back to the Centaur one. Like, it was like 10, 12 things ago. Yeah, that one. It'd be fun if you, just for fun, took some of your chads and put it on that body.
Mike, can we add my chad glasses to one of those?
You already got your chad glasses. All right, that's enough.
Did you name it Buzz, the chad glasses? I just got to know. Is that what the trait name is?
Gosh, did I?
I think I might have. I mean, they look just like my Oakleys, and everybody gives me shit. And they're just like, "Oh, you're wearing Chad glasses," and I'm like, "No, those are my Oakleys."
Are you wearing Chad glasses? All right, what are we doing here?
ETH Towers. We're doing an ETH Tower giveaway.
Same.
All the other ones are the same number. It's all through the same. It's for the whole thing. But maybe you can talk a little bit about ETH Towers.
Me?
Yeah. Well, there's no one
hiding for this. Well, as far as ETH Towers is concerned, we have five. Is it five? Yeah, we have five. We have a whole hall on the artist's floor for ETH Towers to represent the different artists for Funky Monkey Frat House and our we are an artist incubator. So, I worked it out with ETH Towers, and they gave us this whole floor. And looking forward to, being able to display and build out that space. I don't know when that's going to happen. Are you aware of when ETH Towers is going to start letting
us? I don't know when they're rolling out things, but I've seen like they're launching their, you can bring the avatars in and other neat things on there.
And computer. I just saw I saw a video. I don't, gosh, did I see it on Twitter? Where did I see it? I saw a video of ETH Towers where it's like you're from the penthouse view, which is
yeah. That was very cool. That was the top, from the top view from the top porch thing.
Do you know where that was? I could bring it up.
It was on Twitter. It was on their Twitter. You can go find it, and you go find it, and I'll just say a couple things about ETH Towers as well. So for those that don't know, Jason, who's the founder of Ethereum Towers, has been really kind to us in terms of, like Mike said, a floor for the artists. But he's also a dragon advisor at Club 101 Den of Dragons. And here's the view of that Sky Garden view with looking at it through the Oculus.
You know what ETH Towers needs to do, though, is just put ETH Towers in TCG World.
There have been talks. Yeah, totally.
Well, they're on the same platform, right?
Yeah, Unreal.
No, we're on Unity.
Oh, you're on Unity. Yeah, that's what I meant. On Unity. That's what I meant.
That looks good, though.
So, Ethereum Towers.
How many games do you play, Arau? Do you play games? Come on now.
Do I have time to play games? No.
Unity and Unreal are the top two engines, no doubt, though. I'm a gamer, so.
Yeah, no, I'm. Yeah, was known from the discussions. But Jason's one of the dragon advisors for Club 101, Den of Dragons. And so he's not only helped give us this apartment to give away today, but also we've done a number of mint passes have been given away through Den of Dragons as well, where Mike is an ancient dragon, one of the three founding dragons, which
we'll
talk about again a little bit.
You're ancient, bro.
Ancient dragon.
You're not old, you're ancient.
So you can do the draw there. I'm gonna keep giving away wax packs in the Funky Monkey space.
All right, Alex, pick a number between 1 and 4.
Ooh,
no pressure.
I'm gonna go with I'm gonna go with number one.
Number one, good. I'm gonna look away, avert my eyes, and just stop it. 311.
It's got two ones. It's perfect.
311.
311. That'll be
ones. Yeah, you're right.
Toga.
That's a good band.
It is.
Very good band.
Speaking of bands, look at that. He has a guitar.
BC Bell. Look at that.
How nice is that? That is so awesome.
The universe has spoken.
Serendipity, my friend.
That's a nice monkey.
You know what I'm shocked by? Sidon hasn't won anything yet.
I know.
Poor Sidon.
Was
how many did he win last time? He just like kept
a lot because he had like a bunch of Genesis customs.
Yeah. All right, so congrats to BC Ben, number 311.
Is Zach still awake?
Yes.
Because next we're going to talk about Madams and Monsters, which I'm very excited about.
All right, let's see what Zach's doing on his computer.
Yeah.
So what am I doing?
So, Zach, you are a Funky Monkey Art alumni, and Unreal. Ha! Yeah. See, I knew Unreal was in here somewhere. So Zach, do you want to talk a little bit about what you're doing?
Yeah, no, Madams and Monsters is from Mike's incubator, spawning as a custom artist, and then deciding to go out and do my own project. Initially wanted to do something more on the lines of like Magic the Gathering and whatnot, but then just seeing the space kind of being over cluttered by card games and NFTs and stuff, I was like, we want to do something more. So we created Madams and Monsters, and we're making a complete NFT integrated and NFT leveling system for every Madam that you have. So you'll be able to go in, and if you have madams and you'll be able to select different madams, and you'll be able to customize and their names and whatnot, check their stats, and then jump into the game and level them up essentially. And it's a very scenario driven sort of, I don't want to say arcade, but it's definitely got a lot of replayability. There's plenty of humor involved. We got a really fun team working on it to make it as great as we possibly can. And we're just we're really excited about the game. And actually a demo is going to be coming out really soon that'll be available to everybody that wants to play. So just to see like if this is something that you'd be interested in playing. And it's a top-down shooter. It has a lot of, I don't want to say it's RPG-esque elements, but it's more roguelite. You get to select perks, and every time you reset that, these perks will be random. And you'll have to figure out different ways to play to win these objectives. Nice. So, yeah, we're right now, we have, as I said, we're giving away a madam, and those madams are in the game. They're a bit overpowered because they are madams, and that collection is only of 100, including the customs, and all those already are whitelisted and will be receiving free maidens, which will actually be the functional NFT part of the game. So
if whoever gets this, whoever wins this is not just getting the madam.
Yeah, you're not just getting this.
They're going to get three maidens.
Yeah, maidens. Yeah. I mean, you're going to be getting maidens when that launches. So you're getting more NFTs for holding this. And that also for every new set of maidens when we decide, because the cool thing about Madams and Monsters is that it's, we really like the idea of, you know, there's different genres of monsters. And this first part is bloodlust, which is like, you know, vampires, werewolves, mm-hmm. Frankenstein classic sort of monsters. The next one will probably be, you know, we're you know, what do we do, aliens, or we could do cryptids, or, you know, there's the endless possibilities, and it'll allow us to expand the universe of it. And on top of that, we just made a partnership with Den of Dragons.
Oh my.
And Cyber Hornets / Animus. Hey. And if you own NFTs from these partnered projects, including Funky Monkey Frat House, Chad's, anything that Mike does, if you own these, you're going to have special perks and abilities in this game that no one else has. As well as there is a lobby area where you can go and visit, like the Funky Monkey Frat House will actually be a visitable place with its own mission and special thing you can do by owning a Genesis or a Space Monkey or the togas and college and pirates. So it's one of those things where when we were all talking and like, hey, how can we help each other, it was like, well, why don't we build a game where we can check for partnered projects and we can help build utility to help bridge a bunch of NFT projects, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So it's part of this whole entire trying to make the community stronger and bigger. So yeah.
Yeah, that's, yeah.
It looks really cool, man. Good job.
Thanks. Yeah. And I think this is, you know, the part that excites me a lot about this as well is like, this is Zach's vision as an artist and as a creator, building something he uniquely wants into being, into the world, and inviting all of us to help him do what he's more passionate about and go and explore into that. So
I think it's like a blockchain take on like a top-down Diablo shooter.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was thinking like Diablo and like Crimson Land or something.
I'm a huge Diablo guy. That was like one of the first games I ever played was Diablo 1 on my grandma's AOL. It wasn't the greatest, you know. AOL was not the funnest. But in general, like when I look at this, I look at Diablo 2 and I spent a chunk of my time on that, and I actually came together with, if you know Diablo 2, the rune word items and everything else that you'd mm-hmm. build. You'd have to get the runes and everything, mm-hmm. put those together. You get the ethereal armors, everything else, blah, blah, blah. I'm going to go too much into it, but I built some stuff and I went to go sell it, right? And to be able to facilitate selling that, I had to basically bring in like a intermediary person to come in. And mm-hmm. they were somebody mm-hmm. from a website that was supposedly trusted, right? And they'd mm-hmm. come in and they'd middleman it. You drop the armor, you leave the room, next person comes in, they send you PayPal money, they pick up the stuff, boom, transaction's done. If they try to not pay you, the other mediary person, they pick up the stuff before and return it to you, however it works. But with this whole concept and you move it to blockchain and you look at this, you know, and how it reminds me, it's basically what I wanted at that time was something that was seamless, something that everything was facilitated on blockchain. Mm-hmm. You know, you put in your time to the game, you build out stuff. Obviously, there's the NFTX and the bonuses for the NFTs. I mean, it just adds up to.
Yeah, and
that's yeah, part of it. Was my first. Hey, Zach, real quick, what's that gauge at the bottom right that's filling up?
I'm so happy you asked. That is the countdown for right now. That's the boss bar basically filling up. It's giving you a countdown.
So as you like progress through missions and slay stuff, your boss bar builds up, I'm guessing.
Yeah. And basically right now, how we're seeing it is that we want to add, like, in order to earn Matamalians, which is our in-game token, in order to level up your NFT, you will have to run around and do a bunch of certain tasks that are going to be littered around the map that'll be randomized, and you'll earn Matamalians, and you only have like a certain amount of time before the boss spawns, and so you're going to be battling, trying to level up your Matam to fight the boss, because that's the only way you can clear the level is defeating the boss in this certain in this map, because each map has its own objective. So for this map, it's boss oriented, where you will have a certain amount of time to level up to defeat the boss, but at the same time trying to get perks and strategize, like make a strategy on how best to complete other tasks that are going on at the same time, other objectives, in order to get the Matamalians you need in order to level up your maiden at the end.
That's a cool mechanic.
So how long would it take to reskin this game for Chads and have like soy boys coming after them?
Well, no, that's the cool thing is it for like, you know, for we're already doing like a funky monkey frat house in the game. So why not have like a Chad house or something?
No, NPCs.
You know what I mean?
So I just have to say, make an announcement quickly that my Wax wallet is no longer sending. Like I'm over my CPU usage on it, so I'm not able to send out any more Wax packs right now.
Oh. Womp womp.
Yep. Yeah, Mike, I'll stake some Wax for you.
So Zach, you showed a picture of one of the madams before on another chat I was looking at.
Mm-hmm.
Can you show?
Yes. I'm just trying to.
There we go. Boss.
I was like really impressed with the. I was like, wow, like, you know, the game's cool, but look at the characters. They're really cool.
The maidens. We've already made the models. So when you have your maiden, it'll get plugged in and it'll look like the maiden. We've already built it out. And it, mm-hmm. and so that's like where we're really trying to push it so that by the time these actually come out, when we drop the actual maiden NFT, that you'll be able to use them day one.
Their armor doesn't look too protective.
Yeah, I was going to say, some of those maidens don't look too maiden.
It's just flesh wound.
I need some dragon handlers in there.
Have you guys ever seen Hunter?
That's why we gave you stone skin. There's a perk in stone skin. Now she's totally made of stone.
That comes in handy.
Some of our badass dragon handlers in there blowing some shit up.
Yeah, see, that's a cool thing. It's like, you know, we could talk about a partnership, you know, doing a thing for dragon handlers, adding something special that only dragon handlers get. So when, you know, we the system checks your wallet to see what NFTs you have, it'll unlock based on what collections you hold. And we already ran a test. There he comes.
Oh, that's cool.
The boss is here.
Oh, I got to watch. I'm sending more wax. Grandpa gave me more wax.
Does the boss change too, or is it always the same for each level?
Oh, no, he'll change. It won't be the same boss. So right now we just got the bat boss working. He does a few things. He throws fireballs at you, and then if you get too close to him, he'll knock you across the there you go. He'll knock you across the map.
We're all just mesmerized. Good job, Zach. Oh, you know, you
Alex is like, I want to play it.
I like how the bottom right, like the bar filled up to spawn the boss, and then it turns into the health bar of the boss.
Exactly.
So it goes back. That's cool.
Mm-hmm. And there's a mechanic, and I shouldn't talk about it. Okay, there we go. I killed the boss. So then you'll see that you've earned Madamalions, which then you can go in and then you can level up your Madam. And it'll be permanent
upgrades. Yeah.
Yeah. These are permanent, and they will, when we have it set up in the smart contract so that when you buy it, it'll connect to we have a third party server where it'll store this data until you sell that NFT, and that NFT will then basically buy the data with that NFT, and it'll write that new metadata with the new stats in that NFT, so then the person who sold it will actually be able to buy your leveled up character.
That's cool.
You know, like we thought about like World of Warcraft, how there would be these guys who would just, you know, level up to 100, and then they would sell these characters.
Mm-hmm.
You know, for people that, you know, some people don't have the time to level up things, but they do have the money to buy basically stuff that like that. And then we have a system where every week it checks. We haven't quite figured out exactly what would be the best way to do it, but there's going to be basically the top 100 players every week will get an NFT that'll be something like the gun. It'll unlock the shotgun, because right now you only start with the pistol. It'll unlock your shotgun, and only these 100 people for every week will be able to get that NFT. And then we're not going to sell them at all. They're just going to be gifted out.
Mm-hmm.
So in every week that'll change. It'd be like the shotgun, it'd be like the sniper, then it'd be the whatever, this and that, and then the top three. And this is why we stopped. We didn't want to sell any more of these madams, the actual madams, not the maidens, because we wanted to give like the top player every week one of the madams.
I real quick, I appreciate your flavor text of each per there.
Oh.
That's good flavor text.
I can't take credit for it. My father, who is the programmer behind all this, he's got quite a sense of humor, and one of these things. So
whatever doesn't kill you, or maybe you need more of this.
Oh, it has been said white guys can't do this.
Yeah. I know there's some really like good ones in there. I appreciate those details.
Well,
that's so awesome.
Zach, thank you so much for showing us all of this and the work you put into this. And for agreeing to actually give away a Madams and Monsters NFT here tonight. So I think if
is
Mike
the same?
Wants.
Is it the same?
It's the same. It's the rest of the lotteries are the same. So,
Zach, how do you want to do it?
Just do it. Count to five and then click.
All right, you count to five and
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Click.
11:40.
So that is a Greek.
Greek.
A Greek. Greek.
The root of every word.
And guys, if you're watching, remember
it's owned by me.
We're gonna do that again. Mike already has a Matter
of the Monster. He has two. I think he has two or three of them.
I bought them.
I have two. I won one back in the day.
All right, do it again, Zach.
Oh, so 11:40.
Not now. No.
What? 867. I feel so
sorry. 11:40. You lost.
It's Mike again.
I'm just here sending out whack. I'm sending out packs.
So just
Hey, he finally won.
He won finally.
I totally.
I think Biden has a few too.
He was winning so many. Well, that, you know, yeah.
Congratulations,
Biden. That's his luck, though. He's not going to win a Hornet. He's going to win the Matters and Monsters, right? He's got he's got a couple Hornets too.
They're saying it's rigged.
That is such a great monkey. Bust down that monkey.
Sidon has like 80 Hornets or more.
So yeah, everybody gets that wins gets a dragon whitelist and an OG. So keep that in mind, guys.
It's a Dragon Guild whitelist and OG pass.
Nice. The wins?
Hey, there he is.
And right now, if anyone holds a funky monkey, like a Toga or a Greek, or they own a Cyber Hornet or an Animus, or they own one of the Den of Dragons members, there's daily giveaways in the Dragon Guild Discord to win whitelist.
Absolutely.
Collabland, join, go to channel, hit them giveaways.
And if you have a Genesis custom monkey, you get automatic whitelist. If you have Flight Crew in Den of Dragons, which we'll talk about shortly, you get OG pass. So if you get both of them,
that's more.
So OG is a very, you know, it's we gave it to the first 1,000 members in the Discord. So it's kind of selective right now. So that's pretty good rule.
Yeah, wasn't that what number 3 or 4 in the Discord?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yes, you were like, yeah, like 3 or 4, Mike. Yeah, for sure. You're definitely OG. But we did announce a special utility today that the OG will be able to mint a little bit more than the regular Dragon Pass. So that's a cool utility. Nice. Not the last utility, but the first utility of it. Yeah.
So we are getting towards the end, but we still have a couple more prizes and then we can open up and take some questions too.
Before the next prize though, I have not eaten today at all, so I'm gonna go get some dinner with my wife.
All right, Alex, thanks for sticking out as long as you
everybody
did.
I appreciate all of you. This was so fun. Yeah, appreciate you guys. End on a bang.
Alex,
thank you.
We love you, Alex.
Yeah,
send me your address, bro. I got Oregon honey and Oregon pollen. If you send me your address, I can send you some good stuff that'll help you out, bro.
Yeah, it's the bee's knees. That organ.
It's important.
All bro, right, guys.
You wouldn't
night.
Understand how many hives I brought in every year.
So, what we're gonna talk about right now is we're moving into the Den of Dragons Club 101 Web3 Business Club. And so we're just gonna touch base on this quickly. Because we have a metallic dragon to give away as grandpa. There's me. Oh, hello. I guess I could screen share something so I'm not just looking at myself.
I can see you.
What do you see? What do my eyes tell you?
I mean, you're huge.
Thank you. I'm big in some places.
Did somebody say that's what she said yet?
That's a good time.
I'm surprised the Raho didn't send me the private message saying that where's the gift set, bro?
I don't know. I've changed the screen so I don't have to look at myself. So basically, I don't know how many people are familiar with Club 101 Den of Dragons, but it was started by the Ancient Dragons Mike and Sidon, who won, and the Welsh Dragon, who is involved with handling the rads that we were talking about, the airdrops, the IDO staking. And it really is born of the Frat Club, but taking a bunch of these ideas and then bringing them together in a very unique way as a Web3 metaverse business club. So phase one is much more focused on RADs and RAD deployment.
through the memberships you get with either a Diamond Dragon, a Sapphire Dragon, or a Gold Dragon memberships. And they're all at different price points. But the Diamond Dragons are all sold out. So they were one ETH. They were the most expensive, and they're all gone. And if you get all three, then you could get Flight Crew Roll, which now is very hard to get because not only are the Diamond Dragons sold out, but they hardly ever appear on the market. So what we've done is we've created a special gold dragon that is a metallic dragon. Now, if people, there's very few ways to get a metallic dragon. One is by auction. So we have one gold metallic dragon named Kronos who went back to sleep. And he was available for auction for very limited time and no one hit the reserve price. So they can't get him. A lot of people want this dragon. The other way to get it is through giveaways, like today, not very common. And the other final way is if people buy 10 ETH or more of memberships, they'll get a metallic dragon. So those are the only ways to get a metallic dragon. Now, you get rads from it. You also get all of the diamond perks, the diamond privileges. And there's a lot of information here, so I won't go over it all because we've been talking for a long time. But I would recommend you check out the Discord, you check out the website, club101.io, or the Discord is discord.gg/club101. And yeah, what else can I say?
Rads. Artist is Kanan White.
Yes, the artist is Kanan. And the... So phase one, you get rads, access to the business events. We also, it's also a metaverse real estate kind of option because we have a penthouse in Ethereum Towers. We have floor 63 in Ethereum Towers where we can build out offices for different Web3 businesses. We have TCG headquarters in a diamond plot, as well as extensive TCG real estate holdings at this point. Not as extensive as some. in this group.
But
the idea is really to help provide services and support for all the other projects that are here and to help Mike as an artist incubator for the different artists, help the Cyber Hornets, help Zach, help anyone with legitimate business services. So one of the things that I encountered, you know, helping Mike and some of the other projects is right now people want to charge like crazy, ridiculously stupid money for basic services that they do or don't deliver. So we're in this space and we're like, how do you find people that you can trust who know the space or will develop things? And it was like, okay, I want to provide services. We want to provide services, Denim Dragons services. So that's also another aspect of the whole project. And yeah, I could get passionate and talk about it a lot, but I think people want a metallic dragon. And we're going to share more stuff around this. Buzz?
Yeah, I heard yesterday about somebody. It was something I hadn't heard before. And they said they had their contract people come in, right? And do a little bit, push something out. Basically, overall, what I heard was... it was just like the contract devs and what they did. And the price that it cost these guys was around $250,000.
Mm-hmm.
And they didn't even do it right, unfortunately. Yeah. So,
I mean, yeah. That's marketing, crazy. Right? Like people come up and they're like, oh, we'll give you marketing. And it's just like this. It's like the whole, well, we'll give influence marketing and we'll send out some tweets and we'll do some
giveaways. A guy whose name is like Jay and then Sun. And then I'm not even going to end it, but people can probably put it together. He hit me up and he was like, yo, let's have a meeting. And then I talked to him and he was like, yeah, so anybody you know, $50,000, you know, we'll give you discountings. And I'm like, what? What do you mean $50,000?
So, and so that's the thing. It's like I come from a background in digital marketing with like professional agencies and things like that in Web2 and in that world. And, you know, to come into the space and it's like, okay, so people will say, you know, we're going to charge you X amount, but if you're minting, if you're making like crazy more ETH, we're going to charge you crazy more amount. And it's like, well, you're doing the same amount of work. So why don't we have like a base actual reasonable scale? And then we can put a percentage on like royalties and those things. Cause it, you know, we still, but what's being done is ridiculous. So anyways, there's a whole lot of multifaceted elements to it. I recommend you read the business plan. If you're interested, come and check out the Discord. You can ask questions of all of us. I can say like, it's been a pleasure working with some of the people here. Not that, you know, for the team, we've done some stuff with Buzz recently, which, you know, will be coming out soon. And yeah, I have a project that I'm going to show at one point, but first maybe we should give away the metallic dragon. Cause I think that's really exciting.
That's going to be awesome.
Yeah. It's, whoever wins this, this is ridiculous. Yeah.
Yeah. They're going to be so stoked.
Yeah, yeah, it's yeah. Mike, do you want to pick a number? Do you want to start that number generator going?
Oh, Octopi is sending me something.
Oh my gosh!
I'm not sure if I want to look at it.
He's got 8 pies in front of him. He don't even know.
All right, random number generator. How do I share this again? Is that it? Nope.
Oh my god. No. My soul.
This is how we're doing it.
Let's not do that.
I was like, I need to find a screen with the dragon on it.
Just put the yerba mate in front and block out the rest.
Gosh. That's a view. So
hey Matt, can you put
you have your camera on your microphone
in the background or something?
That's the problem. The microphone's supposed to go in front of your face and then the camera's supposed to be over here somewhere.
Okay.
All right. Same numbers?
Yeah, same numbers.
All right, Jordan, I'm letting it go. You tell me when.
Now. And if I win this, I can't get it. So this is
the end of admin.
1, 4,
this is a Greek.
5-4.
You never win anything as an admin.
This is...
Good trouble.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. Good trouble.
Nice. Winning the metallic. Wow. Getting flight crew, diamond perks. That's
it. What's the floor on those right now?
1.25.
Well, there is no floor. I mean, we're pricing it conservatively at 1.25, but it's like the first and only of its kind out there right now. And
right. So
I think It's an outrageous thing because it's
worth more than that.
Oh yeah. Yeah. I mean, if you think the diamond dragon's minted at 1 ETH, mm-hmm. and then this one gets you flight crew and it gets you all the diamond perks. I mean, you get gold level rads, but
is that 1 3/4 + 1/2?
Yeah. That's what you would need. I mean, that said, if you bought like all three of those, you'd get more. Yeah,
2 1/4.
More
two
rads,
and a quarter,
but
2 1/4 is what you would have bought to get to flight crew.
Yeah,
that's at the beginning, so it could be worth more. It's
probably 3.
If you minted it, it's 2 1/4.
Oh no!
And it's got some dope ass artwork. So,
I am gonna share something.
Oh no.
No.
You're piercing my soul now, bro. I need more beer.
I'm trying
get
to find
out of here. Give me
tips. Okay.
Yeah, you're very close.
I know.
Cheers, monkey. I feel better with you. No.
This is okay.
Yeah.
So
the monkey is cheersing us. Thank you. Cheers.
He's got a 40 monkey. Though.
40s. Okay, so we're gonna drop this link here. But can you guys see this?
He's not playing.
See what?
You see the little interface?
No, we see.
What's
the
my screen sharing?
You haven't. Yeah, you have to screen share.
It's Cardano Club, bro. 40 ounce.
Well, I tried to screen share and it was not. I don't want to share that window. I want to share a different screen. Okay, I got to figure this out. I'm not used to this software.
How many tabs you got open, Mike?
Not I got enough. I got not much tabs.
Not here. Enough.
I mean, that's only like 10. I'm used to like 40.
Oh, yeah. Usually I have so many.
It crashes me.
I tend to try to shut down a bunch of stuff before I stream.
Now, is it sharing the screen now?
I agree with that.
No, you're not sharing.
Why is it not doing that?
Because you don't know what you're doing, Jordan.
That's true. I know. I selected it. I hit share.
I'm on BRB.
Oh, Chrome is not giving me permissions. Okay, Mike, I'm going to send you the link.
Okay, send me the link.
Yeah. So basically...
The real Gizmo's telling you have a drink, Buzz.
Yeah. This one right here, this is for Gizmo. It's not Coors Light, bro. I don't drink that shit.
Yeah, Gizmo, I have one for you, too.
Shit. How does this work? Blood and Honey. It's an IPA from Texas.
Okay, Mike, I send you the link. Cheers. On Telegram.
I'm drinking wine.
Leftover. I can't see anything. You're disappearing into your background.
That's okay. I send it to Mike.
Sorry.
So Mike,
oh, there it is.
Where are you at? No.
So this is something that I'm excited to share.
There we go.
So this is something that Den of Dragon Services has put together for Funky Monkey Frat House.
I'm level 5 on the leaderboard. Just saying.
And so I'm going to share, I'll share this in the chat for both the YouTube and in the Discord.
I have no idea what that means.
SB Seba has a very good suggestion. I'm going to switch from tea to Jack Daniels. So Jordan, you go ahead and I'll be right.
Okay. Back. Well, functionally now, if Mike's going to be leaving, it's going to be harder to show things with the
you
screen
can talk
he's sharing.
About it. I'll
but
be back
in the meantime, basically what we've put together here is it's a new interface that we're going to be using for Funky Monkey Frat House, but it's also something that we can scale out for our different partners. And Sweet. It's kind of something that's, you know, I think a lot of the websites that we see in are pretty straightforward and kind of not boring, but there's a lot of information you have to get through. And so, you know, for the longest time, websites have become these like single page long scroll attendee things, and they're not that interactive. And since we have projects that are kind of, you know, fun and interesting and have a lot of things to it, I was trying to think of like a different way that we can interact with the information and have it kind of be like a console or a place that you kind of just are able to check in. And so I tried to move my mouse on the screen, but you can't see that. So when we look at this one here, you can see the in the top left corner, the Funky Monkey Frat House logo. Clicking on that opens the standard web page in the screen. So it has the information, all of our standard landing information. When Mike's here, we'll get him to click on stuff. But, you know, the event one populates with this event's actual information. And when you click on that, it'll take you to the YouTube. So there's that level of interaction. The YouTubes. I sound like a grandfather, Grandpa.
Take you to Coachella too, right?
Take you to the YouTubes. And the project map will pop that open. But what we've done there is we've taken our rather complicated large utility map, project map with all the different collections. And you can look at it, you can mouse over, and you can click through it right there to go to official links. The floor price.
Party like a funk fat party.
The floor price we're going to need to adjust because our floor price has gone up. But basically, all these links are clickable. Hey, Mike, can you mouse over some stuff for me?
Click on something.
Yeah. Well, actually, why is it saying news and not home? What version? You need to clear your cache. Oh. That's what it is, because I sent this to you. So you,
hey,
there we go. Perfect.
Oh, got it. Hold on, let me do it again. Hi, welcome to the Funky.
It's very fast.
Why does it appear so fast?
I don't know. But click on events for me. So boom. You get you can put whatever you want in there. If you clicked on that, it would take you right to the YouTube video. Don't click on it. Click on project map. When you mouse over the different parts of the project, so scroll across the project map, they're going to pop up. They're going to have nice clicky sound. And if you click on them, it goes right to the official links. So we're finding different ways to present information and make it a more enjoyable experience. If you click back on home, so now we're at the whole main page where you've got the newest game that we just launched, because we also have game development for arcade implementations, our mini games, that kind of stuff. We're going to do more things with that, but this is just the basic demo. Mike, do you want to create a name and password? But people can try this on their own. No special characters or spaces, or it borks the thing.
I'm not going to tell you my password.
Well, make up your own new password. Just type in elephant. Okay, sure. Register.
Jordan loves Mike.
Hey.
So here you go. Left and right.
These are basic web-based games. I'll wait. How does it work?
Left and right on your keyboard and spacebar to shoot. So basically, we have some different games here. We actually, if you make it to the end of this, you're going to see the starship, our starship space station, with a hologrammatic floating head of our space station. Shoot that ship up top, and you'll get that. You'll get more energy for your ship or a free life. That's a pro tip right there. Now,
better than Madden's Monsters.
This is Galaga. You know.
This is and so.
Old school.
Basically, we have a bunch of games that we're going to be helping roll out the intellectual property through this, different dialogue, different storytelling. And yeah, it's fun. I hope you can have some fun and play with it. And at the end, there's this, that's what she said. There's the Starship game, the Starship at the end with a hologrammatic floating head. If you click on it, it'll take you to the Deploy Starship website. So thank you to Starship for letting us use the interior visual of our space station.
By the way, the guy that did this, I used to work for him. I used to do a bunch of basically skins for these web games that he did. And yeah, he's a friend of mine and Ben Herrera's. So that's how we all putting all the connections from the past life together.
Get that energy. Or your ship will explode.
Got it.
Okay. So and the other thing with this is that we have the high score set to repeat currently monthly. It'll refresh. So my high score was deleted. Mike, you can become the new high score. But this will also allow different communities. So we're thinking about how we can add utility to our different projects and our different partner projects. So through games like this, you can have high scores and we can gamify that and say, you know, whoever has the top three high scores at the end of the next week, we're going to reward them with prizes.
I love that. That's awesome.
And so you can build in different storyline, different utility, build out the intellectual property. And so the whole idea that we're looking at with Den of Dragons and the incubators and all of this is the point where intellectual property meets the various metaverse applications. So we're helping support our partner projects, the projects that we can develop and incubate ourselves. If people are members of if they have Dragon memberships, we're going to have business events and other things that we'll be launching in our metaverse spaces, but also in our Discord. So you got the Twitter there. You got the Twitter. You got the links down below. And
all these to be links too.
Me too. I know. So we'll have the other mini games. So if you click on games right now, you've got the one game there, right? But if you go back to the homepage, we can basically put the other games in here, but we can make quick access into those games from the background stuff.
Like Easter eggs kind of thing.
Exactly. And there's other things we can do. Like we can actually make that whole background screen. If you go back to the home screen again, Mike. So this whole back, we can make that panable. So we can make it so that it'll scroll through the background and you can have like other pages, other information. If you click on the FMF logo, it'll open up actually our webpage within there. So you can make it big screen, full screen. You can keep it small, but that way you've got a fun front experience with a lot of specific information. And then you can go deeper into the actual site and mechanics. One thing I think we'll probably do is where the home button is, or maybe I'll move a bit of that and I want to have a welcome so that we can have like a welcome video or something where Mike is talking about the project and what it's about. So it just gives people just this wonderful, delightful experience. Anyways,
hey everybody, I am doing something here today.
So I'm really excited to be able to share that because, you know, Travis put in a bunch of work on this and we've had a lot of talk about getting this together. So Den of Dragon Services, if you're a member, you were Preston. I think that we reset the scores. So you have a chance.
You get rebooted.
Yeah. You can get ahead of me before I play again. So partners get access to the services that we offer at an internal price. And you got to go to the end to get the whole storyline. I wrote some good dialogue in there. But yeah, So
do you have the little map with all the other projects on it, or are you not going to show that?
Well, you know what? We can show that. I'll send it to you.
Am I not supposed to talk about
that? I love it. It's awesome. This is great.
We haven't showed that. I gotta figure out where can I find that the quickest. I have it saved somewhere. I'll find it. So basically, going back to the whole idea that Den of Dragons is also operating a bit like a service supplier and also a connecting thing like the Federation in the, to use the Star Trek metaphor. I'm gonna find a file.
Federation of Fascists.
Not the dystopian future one that is really cool. It's all the Vogue. But here, Mike, I sent it to you on Telegram. So basically, here you can see this is the idea where Den of Dragons, you know, we'll have our own mini games and sort of way of systems and connecting the mini games and all that, the interface, and then the different partner projects around there too. So I can't, I have a bunch of ideas and other things we're looking into implementing here, but that I will not talk about right now. So you can see Madams and Monsters down the bottom left. You've got the Funky Monkey Frat House down there. You've got Cyber Hornets up top. And Ben Herrera's unannounced project hiding out at the top. So
You got to make another mountain around there for.
There's a mountain in the top left. I think Dragon Guild, we can definitely have some conversations. So that's the, I got messages. Okay. That's what we've been working on, sort of Den of Dragons overview, Metallic. So that's why it's like the Den of Dragons project is a pretty complicated one for people to kind of, I think, wrap their heads around. But the front thing is if you get the dragons, not monkeys, you know, right off the get-go, you're getting IDO rads. And we've already been dropping those since, like, we launched, we minted, we were dropping rads like within the first week or two. So that's just going to grow in value.
That's because the some of the launch pads were funded prior to the mint.
Mm-hmm. So
that's dedication. Putting your money where your mouth is before you even go.
Cyber Hornets lean and left, apparently.
They which?
Cyber Hornets lean. Oh.
Yeah, there's a little bit of a tilt issue there.
Tower of
Cyber Hornets. A little phallic.
Needs some Viagra.
That stinger is going to get a little bit of an adjustment.
Everything else is straight up and down. I don't know what's going on.
I asked Raho about this, and he said
this image was not necessarily going to be shared today. But Mike,
I asked him about this.
I know. We're looking at that. Okay, so let's do the last giveaway for the bad monkey and the one ETH. Let's do the one ETH last giveaway and the bad monkey, and then after that one we can ETH? Just have.
What are we nuts giving away a full ETH to somebody?
This is a frat party.
Well, not for nothing.
You drink at something I can't even see in your background.
All right, who's talking?
I thought it was a Yoda head first.
Was that Zach? Were you saying something?
Mm-mm.
I think Araujo's trying to say something, but we can't.
No, I'm not saying anything.
He's just trying to hide from the screen or something. All right, so is it the same? 22?
It's
cheers to the frat party.
2267.
All right. Thank you all for being here. We'll have a little AMA at the end if we want.
All right, I'm just gonna roll this, and then
for the one ETH and drum the bad monkey.
Drum roll, everyone, for the one ETH giveaway in 3, 2, 1, 0, 22, 20.
Genesis Custom.
Genesis Custom number 2.
Who's getting an ETH?
7, which is
that's fat.
Well, Genesis, it's definitely not my mom's.
Number 227 is
hey Kanan.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, that's the private investors.
Oh, nice.
Private investor.
So the private investor. So there's a private investor who ordered 40 Genesis Customs that are still in the process of being finished, getting rolled out. So I think he made a very good investment.
Yeah, that was 10 ETH investment paid in advance. So those are still being made. So looks like he's getting a 10% discount on his order.
He's going to be happy about that, I can tell you. As the person who is the intermediary in that one, he'll be happy about that news.
Yeah. It's not Jordan, just in case anybody's asking.
It is not.
Jordan doesn't have 10 ETH to go.
No. If I had 10 ETH, I'd be like buying a lot of frat monkeys right now ahead of the crypto chats. But that is not financial advice. But
no.
All frat monkeys are getting a 0.25 ETH crypto chad in May.
Yes, let's remind everybody, crypto chads launching soon, 0.25 ETH each, being marketed by the very, very successful marketeers of the, it's called the Meta Labs. What's the A stand for?
Alliance? And launch chads on top of that, they're going to be refunded 0.1 like ETH, I believe, from what I've heard.
Yeah.
So, like, if you bought a launch chad, you might get yours back. You can go buy a launch chad. And I think the floor is like 0.2, so you get half your money back and you get some rads. I don't know. Very That's true. Just what I heard.
You're spitballing.
Not financial advice.
Not financial advice. We don't do financial advice over here, but I strongly suggest you think about
it. Do I look like a financial advisor? I saw now that you trimmed your beard, I saw crypto as financial advice. I looked at my trimmer yesterday and I saw number one half, and I was like, all right. Half inch, that's perf. It was too late. I did swipe, and then I was like, shit, what happened? Looked at it. Apparently number one half is actually 16th of an inch.
Don't come in here.
So Buzz have no beard anymore. Yeah.
Sorry, that's not my son. That's just some random kid. So anyways. Launch chads will launch at 0.25 ETH. I'm pretty sure they will sell out relatively well. You get one free with any frat monkey that you buy. So
wind drop.
If you go here and you see wind any drop. Frat monkey at under 0.25, it's a super duper good deal. So all of these I consider to be hella bargain. I really kind of want this guy just for myself. This one's cool.
Yeah, that actually is cool.
Wind drop.
May. Sometime in May.
I might grab it. Yeah, it'll be May. I don't have an exact date yet. They have to do, ramp up and start the marketing. The website's almost finished. And then I think they'll start the marketing pretty soon here. So, like I said, for Meta Bounty Hunters, they went from zero web presence to launch in 3 weeks, 21 days. And then they launched with their marketing, with all the marketing they did in that 3 weeks, they sold first day 4 or 5 million bucks worth of Meta Bounty Hunters. So I'm pretty sure, since this is like a third of the price of the Meta Bounty Hunters, that they should be able to sell these out pretty quick. So if that's one way. Just think of it as being on the whitelist, grabbing a monkey now. Even if you buy one at 0.25, that's guaranteeing you're going to get one. You're on the whitelist if you have a custom. So is there any other way? I guess we could give away some whitelist spots.
We still have to give away, we still have to give away the TCG, the live TCG.
Oh,
silver plot.
We should have done that when Alex was here.
No. 'Cause we gave away the lottery one then, but we're going to give away the silver plot now for all the people who've diligently stuck it out here.
Can I win?
We've been going for 3 hours and 17 minutes.
Can I
Let's win? Go. All right. What do you want to do?
Can we win?
Ever since I've been in the crypto space, I've never been able to win anything.
Well, but you know what? I think the monkey lottery ones, these ones, like, they're random. You're holding the monkey. You have to have bought it ahead of time. I think those ones are easier for people to win because it's not so shady. But when it's like the random giveaways, then it's a bit more tricky.
All right, same numbers?
No. We should give this, because we want to give this away to people who are here live.
Oh.
So this is a live giveaway, not a lottery one.
Hold up. Wait a minute.
Yeah.
We'll do the old comment on the YouTube video.
And then when you're running that, we can also do AMA if people have questions about anything that we've talked about.
All right. So.
Or anything we haven't talked about.
Share. Copy. All right. So, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, this is what we're going to do. Please pay close attention. We're not going to do this. I am dropping a link multiple times in the chat here. That takes you to a YouTube video on my channel that doesn't have any comments on it. You leave a comment, leave 2, leave 10, leave 12. No spamming. These comments cannot be spam comments. You have to say something of some particular value. You can't just type 1, 2, 3, or whatever. But in, let's see, it's 9:19. We'll give you 11 minutes. At 9:30, I will use a YouTube random comment picker to pick one random person commenting.
I give and up. One, I know one, I can't win.
One of you guys will win a silver TC.
Looks like Grandpa already in there commenting like 3 times. He's just like
last time we did a giveaway and Oli the armorer, Oli won something. He won like, was it like a, what did he win? It was like a ship. It was, there was something starship related, I think.
I have metal print of Oli's behind me, but
he's for those who've been asking,
grab it, Preston, grab it, show it off.
He is going to be back in business soon. So yeah, Preston, go get it. Oli does metal prints, and in the Den of Dragon services, we call him the armorer, and he provides internal service pricing, but then externally, people can order prints as well.
There's like 12 metal boxes.
Oh yeah, you're still packed. Okay, Mike, do you have
Dave Moore, who just apparently got here, asked, how do you enter? See the link that I'm dropping in the chat to the other YouTube video? Just go over there and leave a real legitimate comment, or as many as you like. Every comment is an entry. You have 9 minutes. And at the end of the 9 minutes, I'm going to use a YouTube random comment picker. If it's spam, then I'll pick somebody else. So don't
partying.
Copy paste. No,
and TCG
none of that.
With dragons that are being handled with cyber hornets flying around, and there's an animus in the cave, and then you have starships flying above all that, while madams and monsters are like filling in the side of everything.
Freestyle writing a crossover narrative.
Didn't that fill in everybody here?
You missed the Dragon Guild completely.
That's right.
No, I said dragon handlers, dragons being handled. That was part of like the very beginning of what I said.
Okay, I must have missed the first part then.
Be careful.
Dragons being handled.
Dragons.
I went into cyber hornets after.
The dragons are flying the spaceships.
Well, the dragons are
everything.
Are
you don't even
are
know.
Completely wild, you know. So that's why they're handlers and not tamers, you know.
I'm just learning the type. So. Chapter 1.
I mean, if you watched How to Tame a Dragon, it didn't even work out that well. So it's better to handle than to tame.
Yes, they're handled and they love their tamers or whatever.
That's what she said.
Yeah, I'm just behaving over here.
All right, real quick, did
your Ramate turn into like a Irish Moscow or Moscow mule? Like,
no,
what do you got over there?
I love Moscow mules.
Right?
All I was
pretty good, right?
Yeah.
Finished drinking my.
Have you had an Irish mule?
I haven't seen this yet, so I apologize in advance.
Have you had an Irish mule? What I want, you got it, might be hard to handle. But like a flame that burns a candle.
But can't defeat the flame. Thanks, Octopi. So worth it.
That's so awesome.
Did you show the one he did earlier? The other one?
So he's crazy. He's done
the funky
a lot.
One.
No,
the funky one. Show it, please.
There's so many.
It's too good. You got
no,
it.
He's got. Yeah. We have a little channel that he's just filling.
Through this.
No, can it's we? Awesome. Can we get the funky one?
Dance, dance, dance.
Keeps going.
That was maddening.
No, the funky
My
one.
My goodness.
I saw so many people talking about the funky one today.
The funky one.
I felt like it was back at Busch Gardens.
He put it on like Twitter.
He did one with myself and his the Homer Simpson one. It was like
the funky one.
That one dance one?
I say congratulations. Work so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing, look, we made it. Yeah, we made it.
There's too many. I don't know which one you're talking about.
I'll find it.
Every day I'm shuffling that one.
No, yes. That was it.
Every day I'm shuffling it.
Yeah.
That was great.
I don't have that one. I don't think did I play that one earlier? I don't think so.
It's the newest one. He just made it like yesterday.
No, he's made a lot more since yesterday. Like 20 no, it's yesterday. Not. And let me tell you, it is not the newest one.
It's
no. It's not the newest one. There's a folder he's just filling. He's got like the little mask.
I have to share my screen. He's just got full of like. Which one are you talking about?
No, wait, hold on. Let me see.
He's so good.
I think he sent it in Hornets earlier. Let me see.
There's my Sailor Moon monkey.
Yeah. Okay, Mike, I'm going to have to head out. But thank you if you can hear me or you're just watching the video.
It's only half done, Jordan. You're interrupting the song.
I'm sorry to interrupt the song, but I have to go. So
you got
to
go?
I got to go.
We done giving away stuff?
I got to go. I got to go.
Everything's gone.
Late here.
All right. Well, you have to keep track then because
Octopi's been keeping track of it. So we'll get all that stuff sent out.
All right.
But thank you all for coming here and being here, and you can keep going. I gotta go.
It's the one Jordan. Jordan chat earlier.
Thanks all guys.
Good night, Jordan.
Night, Jordan.
Hey.
All right. Nobody wants to watch the rest of that video, right? Sorry, Octopi.
It seemed pretty urgent. He had to go. He's like, I'm sorry.
He had to go to the bathroom is what he had to do, bro. Bring a freaking bottle with you.
Sometimes
these are marathons. You don't.
Yeah, that's how my parents were when we went on long road trips, right?
Yeah, right.
Yeah,
seriously. You gotta use like the Snapple too, right? You're like, here, use this Coke bottle. What are you nuts? Anyways,
Ethan. Snapple was better, right?
All right. So we got about 3 more minutes left. I guess we could watch the rest of that video, but. After we give this away, we're going to wrap up the stream. I do want to have, let's just take the time now to say thank you to everybody. And let's just, for a couple of minutes, kind of highlight your own projects and what's going on. And let's start with you, Buzz, if you're not too buzzed.
Never. So basically, we're about to drop the digital comic.
Ooh,
actually, I have the first issue in my wallet. I think Araujo actually has like the third issue. We did a little testing earlier. There's a slight mobile issue with the reader. It wants you to download it every time that you connect your wallet.
Oh, really?
And it's like a 64 megabyte PDF file. So it's probably not best if it downloads every time. So there's one slight kink that we're trying to iron out before we actually drop it to the public. Technically, it's live on the blockchain and on the internet right now. Like,
what did you use? I remember you were asking about. Oh, did you send it to me?
I'll send you the website. You have a Hornet, right? Yeah, you do. I'll send you the link. But basically, it's how the iframe populates.
I mean, I can go to Dropbox if you just want to show it.
I mean, you can if you want to.
It's up to you.
Go for it. Basically, it's how the iframe populates. And because of how mobile works, it tries to download the file so that you can populate the iframe on mobile quicker. Basically on PC, like if I pull it up right now, which I own the comic book NFT that gives you the gated access to the comic book, it pulls up perfect. There's a slight issue with on mobile. It wants to download a 63 megabyte file every time, which is just a little much, which helps populate the iframe. But at the same time, it's not quite convenient because not everybody wants to have a massive file to download. So there's one little kink we're trying to work out, and then I can drop it to the public. But technically, it is live. Like I said, I own issue one. I think Araujo, he's gone now. He owns issue, I think, four.
You mean copy four or something like that?
Well, we split the, you know how there's three different covers, obviously.
Oh, okay. You would know yeah, that. But it's issue. It's all issue one, but it's just different covers.
It's issue one, but we split the three different cover variants between 1,000 issues not
want,
each.
You don't want me to show this whole thing, right?
I mean, I don't care. I don't think I wish to get a pull off of it.
This is by Ben Herrera, written by award-winning writer Mike Barron, who I've worked with on my own projects. So yeah.
Edited by Mike Miller.
Wow, I don't think I even put that in the credits.
You didn't, but you are. I mean, I saw.
You did it.
He did.
I'm not a credit whore.
Ooh, I like that. Nice.
Yeah, Baron's great. Ben's great. This is a great project. Ben, you know, Ben's gone through a lot of personal stuff. I don't know if he's even told you, Ben. Buzz.
He has. Yeah, yeah.
And he's still cranking this thing out. Yeah, the second issue looks great. Yeah.
I just set up Mike, and he's getting started on the third script.
Oh, cool! Excellent. So yeah,
really hey, great graphics. I mean, unbelievable.
Yeah, it's looking great, man.
I don't mean to interrupt, but it's 9:31, so we need to go find a random YouTube random comment picker. That's the one I use, and then we will go to was this the right one? Let's find out who's winning this silver plot, shall we, ladies and gentlemen? Filter, include replies, filter duplicate users. No, filter comment based on exclude. All right, get the YouTube comments. How many we got? We got 423 comments. Very nice. And drum roll, ladies and gentlemen. Draven, oh my gosh, congratulations, Draven. The frat is love, is his comment, and you are correct, sir. Draven, congratulations. Octopi, was it Octopi that was paying attention to this stuff?
Yeah, that's what the writer said. Ignomatic Octopi, you were on there.
Congrats. All right, and with that, let's go through. Robert, Matt, do you want to pimp up some Dragon Guild?
Oh yeah. Work. Yeah, go ahead, Robert.
No, Matt, you talk. Yeah, I want to hear you. I want to hear what you have to say.
I'm excited about this project right now. It's exciting. All the possibilities.
These guys, I'm working on a lot of the attributes right now. And I'm new to this NFT space, so I'm figuring out how it works. And I'm actually starting to get into the hang of it here. So it's just like a slow start, but starting to move along here. And yeah, I'm pretty excited about the different costumes, outfits, attributes. So I kind of like now I did the armor on the one on the left. I actually, you know, got that armor all drawn out and everything. So I'm excited about that, kind of getting the swords right now and figuring out the gloves. And yeah, it's going to be fun. There's going to be a lot of cool attributes to get the wings of dragons. And I don't know if, how much I should say, but it's, yeah, it's going to be a fun, be a fun NFT collection. I'm looking forward to it.
Let's go.
I mean, yeah, we're so excited about Matt's artwork. I mean, he's given us some really amazing. I mean, you could see from this banner. I mean, some of the stuff we're doing, we're having little dragon mascots, and I mean, it's just kind of amazing what he's doing here. So on top of that, you know, we're getting Matt as a top quality artist, you know, it's amazing artwork, but that's the NFT portion, you know, but the NFTs are not about the NFT. It's about what it does for you. What's the community about?
Yeah.
You know, day one, we're giving everybody a plot of land, and it could be a platinum. You got a 1% chance. Jay said that yesterday. It could be a gold, could be a silver. But the fact of the matter is we're building the best community that we can, you know, from our experiences as being guild leaders, which if you've been a gamer and you know how guilds run and all that kind of stuff, it's a lot of fun. We enjoy it. And then we're bringing it into TCG Metaverse. Everybody gets a plot of land. They can do whatever they want with it. They can build on it. They can farm on it. They can make a business. And then they can come and have fun in the Metaverse in our community center. And then we're going to incorporate all this other utility with all you other guys. So we're so excited about it. I mean, it's so much fun. It's just, I mean, this is like, for me, it's like a dream come true because I can use my imagination and my vision to like bring it into reality. So it's amazing. So I love the community.
I don't want to step on what you're saying, but I think the timing of your project is also very serendipitous to the way, like with NFT Miami and Bitcoin Miami and all of the stuff that Alex and Dave have, and oh, Paris, right? The Paris, and all of the connections and all of the deals that they've made in the last few weeks is going to sell out TCG in the next few months, next couple months, maybe even sooner. I don't know. But it'll be right to the point where when you set your price point, I think you've already set your price point, right? And it's I think when they sell out and your project is actually at a lower price point than the you know, the base price point for a silver plot, bro, people are going to be flooding into your,
and you're not even
into your project like crazy.
Right. Not even adding the NFT value on top of that.
Right. If you have no value for what we're building, you know, you're basically, you know, we're giving at a steep discount to current value of what's out there, you know, of what we have in our inventory. It's a steep discount to just that. So yeah, you're right. I mean, it's amazing. I mean, we're super excited, and then we're just going to build value on top of it. So it's going to be fun.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Grandpa, it's your turn. I love your background, by the way. That's my frat. That's my frat station right there.
Thought you'd like that. Yeah, just a couple of things. We do have a couple more stations coming out. One of our Filipino influencers is next week. And then got a few more coming out over the next 2 or 3 weeks. The big thing to note is, let me check the date.
I heard something about like Alex Becker.
We are in talks, but there's no contracts or anything signed. So I can't say one way or the other on that. We've reached out to him. We're in a conversation, but it's nothing's finalized. May 19th is the last day to claim your extra three ships. Anyone who creates an account before that date will get 6 ships. If you wait, if you miss the 19th, you go back to getting 3 ships. So if you're thinking about playing, you know, go ahead and get in, create your account before May 19th.
I've got mine. I need to get my other 3 ships.
That was Jordan. All right. And with that, Zach.
Hey.
You're
yeah, on. No, Mavs Monsters, everything is steamrolling ahead. We're in full gear, just working every day. And more and more is getting done. You could just go back and look at like the past videos of me showing off what we'd done in just a very short amount of time. And it's incredible. But I'm just really looking forward to this whole entire space expanding and working with the partner, what we can do to connect all of our NFT communities and really build out something really special here. So, yeah, no, go check out Mavs Monsters, follow on Twitter for more updates. Our site is about to go live, I think, next week. So, stuff's coming.
It looks awesome.
All right.
Okay.
Really?
And yeah, with that, cool. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, I want to thank you all for being here, guests and chat and everyone who just spent the last 3 hours and 40 minutes, holy cow, with us. This was an excellent show. I love bringing this whole community together. I can't wait. This is stupid because we just did one right now. I can't wait for the next one because 3 months from now, there is so much more that is going on that I have not been able to talk about that is going to be revealed between now and then. And then it's such an exciting time for me personally, for the community, for everything that's just, it feels just like God is just putting everything together, like some fictional, or not fictional, but like, you know, you ever see like a, what was it? There's a movie where like somebody's walking and there's just things were just falling in his path so he could walk on top of them. You remember what that was? Like he's walking up into the sky and like stairs just fell in front of him so he could keep walking.
Just forming in front of him. Yeah, I remember this.
Yeah, what was that? That's what my life feels like right now. And it's just like, you know,
pretty awesome.
It's all of this stuff is just so bloody exciting. I can't even.
It's like old school Raymond.
Yeah, I can't even contain it. And so, boy, you thought tonight was great. 3 months from now, when we do the third State of the Frat live stream, it's going to be crazy. But until then, try to join us every Wednesday for whatever drawing stream we do. This is how we build a community. This is how we stick together and just kind of get to know each other. We're always talking to the chat, so sorry. Today was very, very busy, so we didn't have a lot of time to talk with the chat. And I'd do an AMA, but it's already 3:42 in the morning. So, not in the morning. It's already 3 hours and 42 minutes into this. So I'm going to say goodbye. We're in the Discord all the time. Link is in the description. Funky Monkey Frat House. Join everybody's Discords here. Follow them on Twitter. Follow them on YouTube. Follow them on Facebook, wherever they are. Just thanks, everybody, for being here. Couldn't be more grateful to everyone who's involved here.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Let's
to you.
Go.
Lift it up.
And happy quarterly Funky Monkey Frat House party.
Happy Funky Cheers. Monkey. Ain't no party like Funky Monkey party. All right, guys.
Cheers.
Love you guys.
Let's fucking go.